There's a great leader in the old Carlton blue, and a team is emerging from the wilderness behind him. If Chris Judd and his boys win tonight, this will be a seven-week start like the Blues haven't known in 15 years. The Saints, though, appear headed in the opposite direction. Brendan Goddard was still a schoolboy when last they started a season this poorly. St Kilda, so resilient for so long, is teetering on the brink. But perhaps tonight is the night for their main man to lead them back. It's Monday night football at Etihad Stadium. A very good evening to Matthew Lloyd. The challenge for Ross Lyon. Lloydy, how does he re-energise this team, which seems to have become bogged down?
Oh, I think it starts in the midfield. Haven't scored 100 points in any game this season. They have to hit the scoreboard. It comes from Armitage. It comes from Goddard. And you're right about Riewoldt. Just 8 goals in his 5 games. So I think a big one from Nick tonight will get him over the line.
Malcolm Blight, the Blues kicked a big score against the Saints to cause an upset this time last year. They're a bit short down the back, though.
They are indeed, but I do like their forward line. Walker's in good form, Betts, and little Garlett. Garlett's the man for me. He's starting off, that didn't change, but he'll come on the ground and kick some goals.
14 goals in 6 outings for the season for Jeff Garlett. Great hit rate.
Yes, indeed, and just to get a judge of what the public and the punters think, the sportsbet.com.au odds started the week with Carlton the favourites, but as you can see, as the week's gone on, they've got shorter and shorter, so I guess that result last year and the form we've seen so far this year would be the reason behind that. But there's a man that can change that perception pretty quickly. Lloydy, what do you think has been the main issue with Nick Riewoldt? Is it supply or is it his own form and confidence?
I think number one, supply, Hutto. St Kilda have failed to win the inside 50 count in any game this season, so that doesn't help your forwards. But he's such a proud man, like Goddard is. Goddard starting in the centre square. I think with White going out, I think that there's Grant Thomas there watching.
Couple of grumpy old men there.
And Mark McClure. But I think Riewoldt with Simon White going out, I think there isn't really a matchup. Is it Jamieson? Is it Thornton?
Well, that's a great question. Is Jamieson going to go straight to Riewoldt? Or will they put Thornton? We're going to get the answer very, very shortly. Ross Lyon will know. There's Brendan Goddard heading down into defence. And it looks as if
Jamieson.
It will be Jamieson.
Yep,
it will be Jamieson. Kaczynski and Thornton trading blows. Del Santo restricted by Carrazzo when they've met previously. I wonder if that'll be the case again tonight. It's a massive Monday night footy, particularly for St Kilda. But can Carlton continue their magnificent momentum? We're about to find out.
Although, it's going nowhere fast in the opening seconds. There'll be another ball up.
Del Santo stood alongside Chris Judd. Gilbert's there now. I'm going to try something different with Judd tonight, Matthew.
That 43,000 for a Monday night game last year. Riewoldt getting himself up into the centre contest, but his kick is picked off by his opponent, Jamieson, who gives to Thornton, to Russell, playing his 100th game for the Blues.
Play on.
Chipping to Robinson, Russell. Robinson and Russell, and Russell eventually. The long ball to Waite, who got the Blues going in this game last year. He marked everything that came his way early. And he and Betts and Garlett kicked a lot of goals, but right now it's Murphy who might be lining up because he's within range, although he doesn't like the angle. He opens it, and he goes for home. Andy Marr.
One of the other interesting matchups down there, boys, is Goddard, who looks like he's starting off half back, and Bryce Gibbs looked like he'd been given the role to stand alongside him for the day, so for the night. So that'll be fascinating to see how that plays out.
And then, of course, Gibbs doing a great job on Adam Good last week. He's got a history of being able to restrict. Well, that was a dodgy kick along the line from Stephen. Just get some hands to it. So back into play. McAvoy is going to have a big role against Warnock tonight. Carrazzo, Simpson, slick hands. Carlton starting on top of the ground. There's Goddard. Gibbs giving him not an inch. McAvoy a fumble. So crucial not to do that these days. You can see the result. Yaron, smooth moving as ever. Delivery just slightly off the mark.
Waite's up. Head up.
And the free kick paid to Waite. And he tried to not have the ball returned to him well then, but unfortunately for him, it came straight back. So Waite, he's capable of going the distance. He doesn't try, so just doing the team thing. Looking for Satanta or Eddie Betts. He did a bit touch of the Malcolm Blights there from Eddie Betts. He put it straight through the middle of the behinds, Blighty.
Glad you've got a good memory. It was nearly one-on-one there. St Kilda only had one extra player back. So if they kick that process up, there's going to be some goals scored here tonight.
So Del Santo with the kick in, and it looks as though Gilbert has been given the job on Judd, which is an interesting bit of psychology, bearing in mind Gilbert's struggles in the early part of this year. St Kilda's footy, Schneider and Gilbert combine. And Schneider sits it up for I'm not sure whom. And Carlton are getting their hands on the footy. Yaron, Ellard, Warnock, Judd, Russell. Carlton building again. Russell picked off by Dempster. Read it well.
He did, and he had a couple of options.
Sintana!
Joe Squilt.
50!
Oh, 50.
50, ran 2 metres over the mark.
Well, that's something that Ross Lyons experienced a bit of late. A few undisciplined acts from St Kilda players in the last couple of weeks, so he'd be happy to have one go the other way. Saints now up to half back at least. And able to work it around with Del Santo and Montagna. McAvoy, the big target. Warnock over to see him off. Snyder, who we know last week, missed some crucial shots at goal. This won't be a shot at goal, but a chance to put them into the 50. Cozzy's deep and is a viable option.
He's gone in the revolt direction with the set. It was always his ball. The Carlton defence wasn't well set up. And Nick Revolt will line them up. And this is an important kick to just set the agenda for the night.
It is. He's kicked 8 goals, 9 this year, but seven goals, 5 from set shots. But you're right, Tim. The first shot for a big key forward is the most important one, especially a man for like Nick Riewoldt, who has had queries over his kicking for a long period of time.
This is his venue. It's his sort of night, but it's a bad start.
Carlton have spread them really well. The run and spread has looked far too easy when they've had possession of the footy, Carlton, not what St Kilda need.
Yes, they just haven't been able to turn that into anything at this stage. Russell with the kick in, a long bomb. Warnock, well played by McAvoy. They got it down to Gilbert, got involved. Blake, a couple of big chances there. Gee, Scotland certainly didn't take a backward step, neither did Stephen. Montagna, Jones, slapdash, but could still be effective. It almost was for Milne. Had a glimpse. McGualter tries to put pressure on. Yaron's getting plenty of the footy early, which is terrific news for the Blues. He gets them out to the wing. They're outnumbered again. Gilbert's going to get there first. Judd playing the role of a defender here, and he can do that too. Oh, no. Was it for the one after the line?
Maybe. Interesting move this, isn't it, Gilbert? Not been in great form, using as a run with player. It's a really intelligent move from Ross Lyon.
Rare to see that sort of conduct call against Judd into the 50 or towards the 50 he goes. Another St Kilda free kick.
He doesn't even know it's his kick.
He doesn't. What a... He's on his way up the ground.
Oh, that shows. Well, maybe it shows anyway. That is a bit embarrassing for the umpire, isn't it, really?
Trigger happy Michael Vozzo early. Kuzitsky to Baker. Too far from goal, high in the revolt direction. Goddard there too, lurching out. No free kick this time. And the ball up.
Well, it's a pretty lively start, Tim, isn't it? It's got some, it's got a bit of passion, this game, yeah.
Just want to highlight Mark Murphy. Clinton Jones is going everywhere with him. Murphy came off, Jones did as well. So he's got the run with tonight.
So Warnock tangles again. McAvoy, decisive looking tap, but straight to Scotland. Bit of hesitation from Dygan. Opportunity for Revolt. Del Santo gets dumped. And then again the whistle required.
Exactly where St Kilda have dropped off this season. Their foot inside 50 pressure. This is where they set the benchmark. Teams have gone past them, but they've got off to a good start tonight.
Again, Warnock the tap into the clear space. Kerno brings it away. Pretty well-placed ball, outside 50. And again, the dash provided by this man, Yaron. He's chock full of confidence, as that showed. Umpire said it was holding the man. And it's going to come back to Yaron. I guess the Saints achieved their objective there of holding him up.
Hello. Jones and Gilbert running with Murphy and Judd. That's two tags. Sometimes I reckon two's too many, so that means you've got a third bloke running the game. The rest should break even.
Ross Lyon, predicted man on man from St Kilda after seasons of this Saints footy, this team defence that they've played. So a major compromise. Curnow kicks forward of the wing for the Blues, where there'll be a throw-in.
Bloody, it looks like there might be multiples on Judd, because Graham just made the switch then onto him as Gilbert got off him, and Judd just come off the ground, so maybe they're going to have more than one run with him tonight.
Yeah, but you don't want to get led to the ball all the time. If Judd's going to run his own race in Murphy, they really don't have to do anything else.
Ellard just getting it onto his boot. Walker and Carrazzo, but strong tackling. There is purpose about St Kilda in the early part. They are issuing a message to the Blues. This is bounce back night for the Saints tonight. If they can't win this, it gets close to the irretrievable stage.
Simpson succumbed to the tackle. And the pressure, it is vigorous, isn't it, so far? Bloody, we've seen a few interesting changes. Does a few extra days for the coaches give a bit more time to come up with a few things?
Yeah, you've got more silly things to think about. No, I think the planning of this, they've had a long time to plan this, St Kilda.
McAvoy, Carrazzo, Ellard under there. So.
And just to follow that up, it's not to say that Carlton haven't done the preparation. They've been in good form. They need to keep going. It's the Saints that have got to catch them.
Yaron with four early disposals and Russell with five. For the Blues, there's Warnock, and there's Armitage, and there's Simpson. What about that for a tackle? And the Carlton fans enjoying what they see so far, as they have for much of this season.
Game on. And McAvoy with Warnock. Montagna in there receiving from Armitage, who was doing the hands dirty work. Awkward bounce for Sipos, who's on the first gamer, 18-year-old for the Saints. Thornton back to the wing, where McAvoy has the height advantage. And Betts' intent, according to umpire McBurney, was simply to box him out. Major height differential there, McAvoy and Betts. In the revolt direction, Carlton gang up on him. Russell, well tackled. Del Santo, this is dangerous for Carlton as the skilled one breaks. Milne and Dygan. Milne clever. Milne very clever. And the Saints have the first.
Milne right now, but Nick Dygan's had some big jobs this year. And you cannot buy footy smarts and Stephen Milne when the ball hit the deck. Too experienced and too quick-footed for Nick Dygan.
So the start the Saints wanted, there's Graham thrust into the action. Simpson, the ball reverts back down to half forward. Outsized there was Garlett, and Fisher was effective. Now Goddard, his first touch of the night. Back for Fisher again. He's found himself loose so far. Goddard just delayed his disposal, eventually sends Grilt away to halfback. The kick is safe enough. I'm not sure what Blake was thinking. Not about the footy. He ran under it, and then that left Dempster in all sorts of peril. And he's very, very fortunate.
He's not confident at the moment, Blake. Just seven disposals last week, and his first two contests has been a sign of a man just out of touch.
See, both Betts and Garlett put an enormous pressure on them, didn't they?
Touch, play on!
Murphy, the quick kick. Judd coming with it, Betts the other way. Jones for St Kilda. Armitage gone.
Advantage.
And the advantage turns into a minor score for the Blues.
It's a skill, isn't it, now to know when to take the advantage and when not to. I guess the blood's always rushing, Lloydie, and you're more likely to take it than not, aren't you?
Good point. That was one that they should have just held their composure and gone back.
I guess if you're the skipper, you just play on whenever you want.
He pulled rank. Fair enough.
Paterno and Del Santo wraps him up. So as good as Carlton have looked so far, they are behind on the scoreboard.
But St Kilda do have to keep attacking, Blighty. I think they don't score enough, and I think Carlton will find their way. Can St Kilda kick a few in a row?
Curnow in trouble. It looks as though he came down on his shoulder. So Carlton have an injury problem early. Their substitute is Dennis Armfield. And he might be into the action earlier than Carlton would have hoped. That doesn't look good. Blues ball, but not for long. Perhaps Russell.
Touch play on.
Krzyzewski bringing it down. Judd not quite able to take it. Gilbert off, Dempster forward. Here comes Revolt, edged under it by Jamieson. Legitimately, Curnow's on the way off. Kick from Jamieson, good. Garlett, midfield.
Right, James, that's it.
That looks as though it's a gone for the night job for Ed Curnow. Low ball in the weight direction, but Blake with him stride for stride. Goddard leans back, goes long. Revolt, Warnock there for Carlton. Hot contest, they all have been so far. Gala to paddle, straight to Schneider, to Armitage, and the barn door is wide open. Cripps leading Russell to it, just needs a bounce, just needs a kick. Got the former, didn't quite get the latter.
Here's what happened to Ed Curnow. Just one of those things by the look of it. Such is the way of modern footy, with a vigorous tackling.
Hasn't there been a lot of shoulder injuries this year? They're getting more and more prevalent.
Heavy tackling.
Yes.
Slam tackles.
Big bodies. Big kick out of defence for the Blues from Russell, but straight back at you from Schneider and Jones. Revolt pretty well held. The ball was wide anyway, and it's out on the full, so once again it'll be Russell's ball. So there's the Jones-Murphy battle. So far, Murphy already three disposals. Jordan Russell is coming in for his ninth. This very early stage. Not even at the halfway point yet. At the first quarter, that not his best effort. And Sipos has taken the mark on debut. Aaron Sipos, 18-year-old. He's a smart kick from all reports, and that was pretty good. And McQualter just didn't handle it at all. Maybe got a shove. Murphy bangs it back to the wing. Can White get into some marking form? Had a tough night last week in Sydney, but kept persisting in the wet conditions. Walker's dashing, and they're clear. The deep kick should be able to do the job. Gibbs got the hands ready, and they used them perfectly when they arrived. And he can line up for goal for Carlton's first.
And watch this. Here, Curnow walking off with the injury. Watch Brendan Goddard come into play. And Liam Montagna, sorry.
So I thought we didn't do that anymore. It was a few years ago at the Gabba, I think I saw that. One of his teammates caught one.
So our attention turns back to Bryce Gibbs, playing a defensive role largely tonight on Goddard as a forward. He kicks it more like a defender than a midfield forward.
Inside 50s, 8 to the Saints, 4 to Carlton, and it's due to the pressure of the Saints inside 50.
I think they've won the first 15 minutes or so of the night. The game's being played on their terms, although Grilt has given the ball up here.
Hey, bad kick. Hey, Scotland!
Thank Scotland you. To take it for
Come
Carlton.
Here, David.
Contested marks there, 5 to Carlton, 2 to St Kilda.
Kick high in hope. Gibbs third in line, wait the crumb, swinging optimistically, hasn't quite got enough of it. Blake, St Defence has the scoreline there as its friend and uses it, and Carlton have five straight behinds.
Blues are winning around the stoppages, 6-2 so far, numbers there. Time runs out, Del Santo. Plays the percentage as Fisher the target, and Robinson could do nothing to stop him taking the money. So they lead by three at this early stage. Up and under for Revolt. Cozzy comes late and great. Almost dragged it down. McWalter, Jones, Sipos is there. If Milne can bring it to ground, they have the numerical advantage here, the Saints. And can they use it? Maybe they can. Yaron, a long tackle, too long. He lingered. And Milne will line up. Second goal, perhaps, for Stephen Milne.
Good work there from the Saints. They took all the numbers up the ground, and they're creating the space over the back. And this man is the most dangerous, or one of the most dangerous in the competition when he's got space over the back. He set him alight in this first 15 minutes.
As you saw, has kicked goals against Carlton regularly. That is not what he was after. So both sides have missed some opportunities now. What do you make of it, Bloody?
It's a fantastic contest right now. But what's happened is St Kilda have had poor starts. I reckon they've worked a lot on this start. Let's keep it tight. Let's keep the scoreboard really tight.
Now Judd. The kick
O'Halpin. Made an auspicious re-entry for the Blues in Sydney. Bad kick. Inauspicious. Jones to Baker. St Kilda's front 50 is open when they go forward, but this kick not well placed. O'Halpin, and this time he puts it into a better spot for Walker. Being mown down by Armitage, but had time for Gibbs. Still 80 from goal.
Big fella in the square.
Carlton haven't been able to set anything up. Oh. Now they might. Betts can line them up. He'll be kicking from pretty much on the plate of 50. Behind the play.
Thanks, Andy, that's your line. He's on the
one back from earlier. Carlton needing a goal. Betts not taking the shot. Yaron from a long way. And it's six straight misses for the Blues, although one of those was rushed.
Well, it's been St Kilda whose accuracy has been a real Achilles heel for them so far this year. So much Carlton. As Graham takes the mark from the Goddard kick in. Told then to steady it down. This is Graham's first kick of the night. As long as he can. Three big targets there. But Jamieson was the man. They took it for the Blues.
There are virtually 36 players in that quadrant of the ground.
So try finding a mate in there.
What you need is a hanger here. Someone to take an absolute bomb.
Not from that one. Jamieson. Back on the wing. Just as long as he can and quite wide. Good St Kilda numbers there, are helping working against the numbers and then against his own teammate. That made life very difficult for Bryce Gibbs. Del Santo happy to take it away. Bit of indecision between Gilbert and Riebold, and the synchronicity certainly wasn't there, and you're gone there. Advantage. Gilbert, the handball over top, quick from Russell. Simpson just a fraction too far out to score a goal. So he passes again, and Bryce Gibbs will have another opportunity to shoot for goal.
Here's friendly fire. They've been pretty close over summer too.
They have been, and this man, Bryce Gibbs, bad set shot before, but he's one of their better set shots as Sam Gilbert comes off the ground for that effort where just didn't know his surrounds, his awareness, and got caught for dropping the ball.
Bryce Gibbs, 2 goals, 3 for the season. Coming into tonight, has already missed one shot at goal. You can see Justin Gazitsky.
Oh, he's got 50.
Well, you can hear that. You could see that he was using words, Justin Kaczynski, but how close was he?
Michael Vozzo's on the job tonight. He's
5 metres is the rule.
Well, even Carlton not going to miss from there.
Very stiff up front. Just want to see this replay. Justin Kaczynski, you see him in the background trying to put off Bryce Gibbs. Really, I know we talk about spirit of the game. Surely you just let the man have his shot, and that's a too big a penalty.
Well, it's his visual awareness that's often been questioned. That time it was the audio. Carlton gets its first goal of the night. They needed it too, because they might have become haunted had they not broken through before too long.
It was distance away, right, sure. It can't have been what he said.
I mean, Matthew, that's garbage.
It is.
That's rubbish, isn't it?
I reckon it is, yeah. It's too big a penalty, and you just let Gibbs take his shot. Justin's not doing anything. Judd, nice ricochet to Simpson to Murphy. And this is promising for the Blues from outside 50, and in a flash they have their second.
Let's just have another look at that Kaczynski incident. We'll try and get a slightly better perspective on how far away he was.
That is.
There is the 5 metre rule,
but it's probably hard.
Well, it's hard to tell completely from that angle. Meantime, they're 9 points up, and it might continue to multiply here. Chris Judd, Gibbs for his second. Just took a split second too long, you fancy. The pressure was applied and had its effect. And it's another miss for Carlton.
St Kilda must attack though, Hutto. They cannot just try and hold on. They have to score 10, 15 goals themselves.
Oh, Jamieson, another good win over Riebold. Just a subtle little edge out with the shoulder. Scotland swinging it long. Walker becomes something of an acrobat up there for Carlton. Big McAvoy brought down. Jones, smother from Walker. Baker, Jones, heavy workers for St Kilda. Judd likewise for the Blues. Not sure how he got that out. Dempster to Graham. It is hot inside. The Saints win this exchange. And here's their main man back there. 150 gamer. Big Sam Fisher in the Cripps direction. Dygan with him. Cripps emerging. Did it well. Carlton though with numbers. Russell running into Revolt. Jamison's doing well early.
Great pressure.
Joseph bringing it down, but straight to Blake. Blake to an open 50 again. Stephen and Yaron. And the boundary umpire will come into the frame.
It's a big win for St Kilda, that, in the end. I mean, they really turned it over.
Here's Nick Revolt. This comes a time you've got to push back on your opponent. He just keeps pressing up at the football. It's happened to him in grand finals. He's got to be stronger in the one-on-one contest.
Yaron again breaking clear. And happy to indulge in a bounce. So confident was he. And his delivery perfect for Garlett. And Carlton are out. Held up for the moment at least.
Where's the confidence?
Wade doesn't get the service he was after, but Carlton have got it to the win.
Hutto, remarkably, Ed Curnow's reappeared from the ruins with the other shoulder strapped. It looks a little bit restricted at the moment, but they certainly haven't ruled a line through him at this stage. You can see him feeling for it there, but he's not out of the game just yet.
Gee, was that a handball? Didn't really look like one from Warnock. Carlton get the advantage of that anyway. Well done, helping to keep it alive. Dempster tries to not only nullify Betts, but get away with a footy. Half achieved that aim, but not completely. Judd destructed by hand this time. Murphy instant with the kick. Goddard seemed to have it covered with terrific assistance down there from the ever-reliable Fisher. And he is Gwilt on the way out. And as Lloydie said, their instruction must be to attack and get it moving, and that's what he does. McWalter, will he push go? No, he's decided to hold things up and bring it into Graham. Graham, he does decide to move initially. And that was a good decision. Montagna, this is a terrific build-up, Stephen. Montagna can get it from there if he hits it well. Milne. Oh, was he off? He will be soon, knowing Stephen Milne. Now he is. And that is why. Big goal, that one, for the Saints.
How good was the run and carry from the Saints? No doubt this has been a change. They've had the week off, or they took on Adelaide last week, and I reckon they've worked on this. It'll help the forwards.
They'd be in trouble this year up forward without him. Well, they are in trouble up forward. Here's Montagna. He can have another go from the same range. And he's offline. Curnow back on the field. Doesn't look comfortable.
No, not at all. It's like it's being held up by the tape, but literally. Jamison's turn to bring it back into play. A mighty thump. White, big leap at Kaczynski. Even more superior in the air. That's a good sign for the Saints. You can just bang it straight back in again. Set it up for Revolt. Jamison works him out of it. Dygan did everything, but then didn't take the mark. Yaron, looping handball okay for Gibbs, who's back in defence for the moment. And now Simpson can run. Clock says a minute 35. What's the attitude going to be like here for Carlton? Around the edge they've been going. Happy to bring it back into the middle. Yaron. See Murphy. Or even Russell pushing up for disposal number 11. Very wide kick for Walker. And needed to be clean there. Wasn't able to be.
There's no doubt he would have had a jab, Curnow, in the break. And I think if he's no good now, you'd bring Armfield on at quarter time.
They just keep him out there maybe for the rotation and all that for a little while.
Clean tap to Warnock, but no takeaway. Murphy. Now Schneider. Clever Kaczynski. Neat work. Armitage not able to break. Scotland the tackler. Here's Cripps. Clever hand in there by Russell. Following up with a good tackle. Cripps fighting on well though. Resilient stuff. Now Gilbert. Good centering ball. Milne could get his third for the quarter. A hat trick for Milne.
Clean up though.
Bit of a scuffle after that goal.
There's some feeling in this. And we actually heard at the end Andrew Walker made a verbal complaint to the umpire about what happened there. And I'm pretty sure he said, we'll have a look at that on the tape afterwards, put a notice in. So we'll see whether anything gets followed up on that. 3-4-22 to 2-6-18 is the score. Stephen Milne didn't get a touch inside the forward 50 last week in the first half. He's been deadly tonight with three goals. And the Blues will go in behind at quarter time unless they can strike here. The extra number working for St Kilda there. McAvoy getting back deep to help out. All hands on deck. Good signs all over the field for the Saints, even though Carlton have looked pretty quick out in the spaces. Times in this opening quarter. Kaczynski.
Yours, Henry.
And that's on the full. With 9 seconds left, maybe there's time for the Blues for one last strike.
And this matchup I'm worried about. They may have to look at that at quarter time. Joseph and Milne out of the goal square. He's already had Dygan. Now Joseph. Maybe Jordan Russell would be the best matchup for Stevie Milne.
So Warnock off with a split eye, not able to take the free. Halpin will come on for the Blues for 9 seconds. Time enough for a goal to be kicked if everything went right. And Murphy hopes someone can take a mark. A lot of Saints up there. 2 seconds. Where's Nick Davis? So St Kilda by 4 points. And barring an infringement, you'd think that will be the quarter time state of play. Willing quarter, intriguing quarter.
Fantastic quarter, actually. Inside 50's about even, and there's been a real lot of feeling in this game. Brent Thornton back. Still a lot of pushing and shoving going on as the teams break up now. Fantastic feeling. So it should be. It means a hell of a lot. And here we still are. Oh, they won't go away.
They're into the captain. They win it, Chris Judd.
Sam Fisher, stay out. Let it go.
Stevie Baker and Judd started with.
Let it go now. Eddie, Nick, let them let go each other.
Gee, we haven't seen scenes like this for a long time. Not since the night between St Kilda and Collingwood last year, perhaps. I don't
know. Mitch, Mitch. Justin, over to your huddle.
Come to play the Saints.
Well, they have.
Back you go now.
Needless to stay.
Couple of old Caulfield from there in there.
Let's go, Jason.
And the umpires are powerless in this situation, aren't they?
What, at the break. I just reckon people react to the whistle. I wish they'd blow the whistle. You know, just drive everyone nuts with the whistle.
All right, a few smiles now. We can safely take a break. But as they say, don't go anywhere because the next chapter is not far away. What a Monday night footy it looks like being. There was plenty of action in that first quarter, but after the siren, there was even more. So plenty for the coaches to work with, discuss at quarter time with their troops. Stephen Milne, a lone hand up forward, but a really bright start by St Kilda. 3-4-22, Carlton 2-6-18. Now, this is how the fight started. Kurnow getting injured, having his shoulder taped up. That's the second St Kilda player, Kaczynski, to target one of his shoulders. And then I thought it was just going to settle down at that stage, and then Chris Judd came in. He went straight back at Gilbert. They've had a couple of goes at each other in the first quarter, and then she was on, boys.
Yeah, I think it's Chris Judd would have taken exception, and so did Satandro Halpin at what the AFL's been trying to crack down in this game, and that's targeting injured players after the siren. And I think they took exception to that, but at the same time, St Kilda have come to play. They've been under a lot of scrutiny, and they want to take a big scalp in Carlton tonight. So Justin Kaczynski, I don't think anything will happen to him, but they wouldn't want to see any more of that, the AFL, as this game unfolds.
All right, so what do we make of the actual football? As you said, St Kilda have made a good start. Milne's been their only goal kicker. Are you happy with how they're playing, Lloydie?
Oh, I'm happy with their intent, but I still think that they have to find some other winners. This man, Nick Riewoldt, has been outpointed by Jamieson in the one-on-ones. He needs to find some footy, because you can't expect Milne to kick six or seven tonight.
Second half then. What will be the follow-up to the fight? Warnock, the great tap down to Murphy and then to Scotland. Time on the side of Carrazzo. Can't hit a target, at least not on the full. Walker trying to fight and scrap, but Wilt got clear. Now, Revolt knew that wasn't coming where he wanted it to. Jamieson didn't mark, but he had the best backup. Yaron didn't look great through flight. Murphy was able to see off Jones well enough. Gibbs knew that Goddard was right there and controlled it beautifully. They needed one more handball. They're in the clear, Carlton. That wasn't to be the case, at least not yet. Diagon, they're under pressure still. They found a way out, and that was out the back. Jamieson did nicely. After Carrazzo had helped him achieve that aim. And then the quick kick from Thornton is a real up and under. It's a shocker. And Blake had all the time on his side. Off to Del Santo. And they go forward again.
Poor kick. Poor handling by Gibbs. Could let St Kilda back. Judd in there. A one-man band for the Blues. And he just about won the contest.
Okay. No, went over it.
Michael Vozzo, very busy opening term. The action seemed to follow him. Goddard shaping to take it, let it go. Armitage, Kuzitsky. Fired up, Kuzitsky. Montagna, Blake not expecting it. Now Judd for the Blues. And this is a useful looking move. Simpson, Walker, Wilt right with him. Trying Walker up. Gilbert emerging. Dempster. And he goes towards an open spot where Milne on fire. Three goals in the opening term. Kick the sweep for the Saints to Stevens. Stephen, rather, to Revolt. In the Kuzitsky direction. Had the set. Had his name on that one. St Kilda with the tall timber at that end of the ground, and in that contest, Carlton's lack of height was exposed.
He's in the ruck at the moment. McAvoy's on the bench, so that was him pushing forward on Warnock, boys.
And it's when he's at his best, when he launches at the football, and I think he's more suited to the ruck role now than being a permanent forward.
As Revolt had gone up the ground, Kuzitsky got down there. Now to finish it. That looks good. Glorious kick. Saints stretch the lead.
Well, they made the move on Stephen Milne. You get a sense down here that he just wanted the ball kicked in his direction with Aaron Joseph alongside. You feel like Milne believes that he's got Joseph exactly where he wants him at the moment. Jordan Russell's gone to Milne for the time being, but that's a matchup the Blues need to get right.
Thank you, Andy. Kuzitsky's still in the ruck. Which way will this one head out of the middle? Well done, Armitage. Battling on. Carlton had some numbers behind the pack. They realised that. And Diagon knew he was under the pump. Moves it instantly to Robinson. Murphy bounding, couldn't wait to receive. And then works it inboard. Beautifully judged by Gallant. Not paid as the mark, but now with the extra numbers, nice pop over the top from Walker to Gibbs, who strolls in to get an important one back.
This is clash between Fisher and Armitage. He's okay, but looked pretty sore for a minute. Hurt him. Probably winded him more than anything.
They were both hurt, yeah. But they both recovered. Warnock, the tap for Carlton. Armitage, the footy.
This is so important now, this centre bounce. I mean, Cozzy's had a really good start to the game. Murphy and Judd have been terrific. This is where St Kilda now need to win some ball from these 50-50s.
Goddard, third man up for the Saints. Again, no takeaway.
The matchup of Milne and Russell really hurts the Blues. Russell's got 11 disposals leading for Carlton, so they're going to lose his run with that matchup.
Here's Goddard, indifferent start to this season. Kuzitsky really looking as though he's offering something tonight. Revolt, Jamieson, lucky to get away with that perhaps. Took Revolt out when it looked to be his mark. Yaron, good kick, and that's a push. Maybe that's a square off. Yaron's been magnificent for Carlton. And again, he stands up under pressure to Ellard. Well-placed ball for Waite. Oh, wonderful athlete. The mark just impeded for the moment. Robinson now, always unpredictable. Waite, well tackled. McWalter got him, wins the free kick for the Saints.
Dislocated finger, Andrew Walker off the ground.
Thanks, Andy. Fisher moses his way up towards centre-half back, and he saw Graham in the clear. Where to next? Waits for reinforcements from behind and through the middle. So it's McWalter's task to hit a target. And up comes Milne, Snyder, I should say. And out wide for Revolt. So that was good systematic play by the Saints.
Actually, they've actually moved the ball very quick, haven't they, Matt? They've been really good at tonight, St Kilda, I reckon.
Yeah, they've been far better, Blighty, you're right. And look away now. Dislocated finger, that won't stop him too much. But this is a huge kick in the context of the game and also for this man. He's just trying to find his confidence. He's working really hard. Got some space from a double lead on Michael Jamieson, but this is where he needs to finish.
He'll know that. He goes about his work quickly. And it's not the result he was after. Quite rust on the kick.
Here's the ball drop, Blighty. What do you think?
Yeah, I like to see the hands even on the ball. I reckon the best kicks, at 9 out of 10 of them, all had even hands. One hand lower or higher than the other, I reckon the guide down's not as good.
Judd not able to hang on. Montagna, Del Santo gives it back to him. Does well with the left. Just too strong for Cripps. Still a dangerous one for the Carlton defence. And Jamieson blazes for Scotland. Had a very good season so far, the former Magpie. And he places that reasonably well. Neither Dempster nor Joseph quite able to get to the drop. So not a bad outcome for the Blues.
Tim Curto coming off. He's in real trouble. He can't get into the contest with any confidence at all with that shoulder. It'll be interesting to see whether they make a call on him here.
Warnock down to Allard. He just couldn't quite get the run of it.
Andy, you make a really good point there. I mean, when you're that sore and you're that not confident, you may as well not play. He may as well use the sub.
Yeah, he had had a quick word to Rats, then Blighty, and shook his head in the negative. So I reckon they're only moments away from calling Arfield in here.
You're playing one short, anyhow.
Armitage, McAvoy. Good positioning from Snyder. Late and effective Thornton. What about Yaron's impact on this game? Had to handball into the space there and hope that it could have sat for his teammate Carrazzo. Instead, Del Santo with assistance from Reebok. Look at Dagan. Another one of those acrobatic marks. Totally fearless. And now they're running. Jordan Russell has time and space to work with here. Up to Simpson. They've got the halfback. They've got some numbers in the corridor. If they see them. Oh, he saw them all right, and they are away.
Yes, Warnock with a man to feed to, and that man was Ellard. Bad kick, though. Wilt can attack this. Waite right with him. Wilt had some allies. Betts an important hand in there. Baker under pressure. Just beat the gallant tackle. Here's Scotland. Brought down legally. Betts swooping like a thief in the night.
In the last 4 weeks, Betts and Garland are ranked 1 and 2 in the AFL for pressured acts. But not only, look, no wonder Ratton didn't drop this man. Not many can do that. Beautiful on the non-preferred, Eddie Betts.
Oh, that was just great stuff. Exhilarating to watch, no doubt, if you're a Carlton fan. Gibbs out of the middle, and they share it around the armfield, so they have activated the sub. Out to Waite. Just not quite right at the moment. And here's Graham to really make them hurt. Love to bounce a couple of times. Milne works his way back to the goal square. Graham decides to handball, and that means the shot comes from Cripps instead. I'm not sure the young man was just really ready for it at that stage. He misses when St Kilda would dearly have loved a goal. So there's the dejected Ed Curno. He's had a wonderful start to the season. Let's hope the injury doesn't curtail that too much.
Dennis Armfield, a runner, will speedster for the Blues into the fray. Russell. Well, the kick looked good off the boot, but the direction not so hot. Scotland, two of them got him. Graham. Jamieson has it covered. Taken the honours on Revolt, who hasn't helped his own cause with two misses from set shots. Here's Armfield. Ellard able to run onto it. Saw Walker loose. He missed him, but it still might come off for the Blues. Murphy having to take it away from goal. Ellard again turning it over, and Gilbert picking it up down low. Yes, three sloppy disposals from the Blues. Not good enough. Wilt to Fisher. And what a great defender he is for St Kilda. He had it to Stephen, but he dropped one he should have taken. Waite, well tackled, he's gone. No, play on the call. Gee, he did about 490 degrees there. Here goes Stephen again. Support from Blake. Saints on the build.
They are, and here's Revolt. Six disposals versus Jamieson's 10. McWalter relishing the space. Time to hit up Goddard, who gets a lead about 40 out from Cozzy, but he also had Armitage as another option further to travel to goal, but it was a safer pick for Goddard in the moment.
Not this man's strength. You wouldn't think he'd make the distance from here.
He thought that too. You think Del Santo might. It sets sail. It's line ball. And it was in rather than out. And
try.
He's a former rugby player, Dennis Armfield.
He looked like he knew how to get it over the chalk. Scores level. Halfway stage, not quite reached in the second quarter. What a game.
This was his first code, rugby union. Here's Dygan. And wait. 30 all is the score. Second game of four. Second 30. Quarter anyway.
Yeah.
Gibbs.
I'd like to be 30-40, wouldn't you?
Hold it!
And serving.
40-30.
30-40 and serving,
lead.
Yeah.
Djokovic got Nadal on the clay yesterday, so upsets happen, and St Kilda are playing for one now.
Hasn't gone yet, fine there.
There's going to be some tape on a lot of heads, I reckon, before this night's done. Brings back memories of that night a couple of years ago when Chris Judd had his nose broken in a contest between these teams. That is, as you see Blake there, and he's non-preferred.
He's Jared Waite from before.
That's okay, but what St Kilda just did there, kicking out of bounds, that's what they've been doing for the first five or six rounds.
Yours, Jack!
Jared Waite, of course, has had his connections. That one missed, and that is a goal from Walker.
Adam Snyder, we see him sitting on the bench. Look at this. This is exactly what St Kilda have been doing for the first six rounds.
The players still get dragged.
Not as much these days, but that was disappointing because they've been good in the first 40 minutes and they've gone back to what they've done.
Helping got the tap straight to Gilbert. Forwards love that sort of service. And Cozzy has rediscovered his marking touch. Defenders hate it, don't they, when there's a break as clean as that, Lloydie?
Oh, centre clearances, important as they've ever been because of the press.
And quick centre clearances.
It is, and you get in there before the numbers are back. But this man, the nice kick of the footy.
Four marks tonight. Again, just showing us what he's capable of. Kicking hasn't always been his strong suit, though. And St Kilda have wasted their share of opportunities both this season and tonight.
He's as perverse as they come. He kicked the tougher one, missed that straightforward shot. Yaron to Carrazzo. Yaron having to loft here and hope. Fisher there would be hard to beat. Walker crashed in. Gibbs for the Blues. It's open up ahead. Murphy is skillful. Gibbs, great move. Gallup to just about go all the way. Backs his pace and finishes for Carlton.
Great goal. How good's that? I think Garlett and Betts right now are the most exciting things happening in the forward line in a lot of ways, aren't they? As a small chase and kick goals, it's exhilarating footy.
Oh, it is. He took Stevie Baker up the ground, turned him round, and he just could not run with him. But a big miss from Kozitsky.
There's no Dustin Fletcher, is he, Jason Graham?
Right, held to him. Okay, guys. Okay.
Margin is 11.
You can almost see Garlett's mind tick over there as though he realised, I've been here before. I've just got to run that little bit harder than last time.
O'Halpin did the rucking and the roving, and when they can get it out into the open, they look deadly dangerous, the Blues. Over Waite's head, Walker versus Dempster, and now Fisher with an unusual-looking handball to Snyder. And where's he kicked that? Straight to Simpson, who knew that Tsipos was coming, and well done to the young man. At least didn't allow Carlton to get the clean break. Eventually they do, though, through Simpson. Oh, he's walking a fine line there. So fine, in fact, that it's out of bounds on the full. And in these days of congested footy, Lloydie and Blighty, the fact that Carlton have got those blokes that are just so explosive makes them dangerous, doesn't it?
Absolutely.
Matthew Cruiser looking on, not many weeks away, which will gladden Carlton hearts. Big McAvoy. He is a big man. And, he had eyes for the ball there. Now, has Montagna with the odds stacked against him. Jamison. Been a cool head so far for the Blues.
This is a really important phase of the game. A bit over 8 minutes from halftime. Carlton with a mini break. McAvoy
kick to kick.
Playing a bit of kick to kick.
Off to Del Santo. Into the middle for Schneider. Garlett arriving. Snuff out any chance of a quick breakaway for the Saints. There's some space to work in out here on the flank. Armitage, let it sit for him. Guide the ball in front of Milne. Milne's been quiet in this term after dominating the three goals in the first. This time around, he's had just the one disposal. Lining up for his first score of the second quarter.
Hutto, he and Riewoldt started the night on 445 career goals each. Milne's stolen a march here. He's on 448.
And that's where he's going to stay for the moment at least.
Chris Judd only the one touch this quarter, Matthew.
What's he had for the game? Just nine
in the first. I've just been watching him. He's just... He's just struggled to get in the action here.
445 is a lot of career goals, Malcolm. How many did you get over the years?
Oh, I've got a couple of careers in Adelaide on this, but yeah, about that many.
Someone just told me 444.
Yes, and it's, yeah.
Yarinda Walker, Scotland laying the big tackle.
Oh, free kick. Absolute free kick.
That was good. Good call. Silly from Stephen Moore. So it's a Carlton free kick for a push.
Andrew, your kick. Andrew, your kick. Go back.
Surely he was holding the ball first, though, wasn't he?
Right out. Too high.
No prior opportunity. Was there an attempt to get rid of it?
Yeah, but I'd rather see that not paid than paid.
It was a line ball.
Run!
So Walker's ball. Carlton by 10.
What's the matter with this ball? I must say, that's seven or eight kicks this last 5 or 6 minutes have been absolute rubbish. And I do say, sometimes there's some footies. Bear with us. But there is some bad footies, aren't there?
They change them these days, Clyde.
That's what I'm saying. It's just...
Now, play on was called. Montagna was standing outside the line.
It's throwing, is it?
And he changed direction while he was still out, so I think the ball's been called out.
Yeah.
The only defence of the balls is Allard and Andrew Walker aren't the best users.
Yeah. So Schneider?
Schneider?
Schneider too, yeah.
Wasn't last week. Armitage. In the back. Now Armitage got them moving quickly. Schneider. That looks like pretty good delivery to me in the middle. And now Graham comes from the Riewoldt handball. Cozzy's loose again. He should get this one. He does. And surely he'll convert. He'll cut the margin back to four.
Well, no one short down there, Hutto, when McAvoy came back on the two. Carlton, Tors, Thornton and Jamison had to suck back. That meant Riewoldt could get on his own in the middle of the ground. They were at sixes and sevens trying to cover the three big St Kilda talls. They had no idea how to set up then, the Blues.
I'd love to know how many times Schneider gets by himself on a footy ground.
So Kaczynski... It looks plain and simple, and that's the way it turns out to be. Big goal for the Saints.
Saw Riewoldt lead Jamison up the ground, but look at this. In the one-on-one contest, Jamison leading the contested marks and Cozzy coming next in line. Nick's working really hard, but he's got to compete a bit harder in the one-on-ones. The B teams are racking, right. Blake and O'Halpin. Saints stay close.
Both sides have already passed their average contested marks per game. We're only three quarters of the way through the second term.
Ferrazzo to Yaron, who has been impeccable and full of confidence. Clean in his work. Delivery good for Waite at full stretch.
Oh, no.
That was very optimistic. Dempster, Goddard. A throw, though, against Dempster. That's a big call from umpire Robert Finlay. He's the man they say is a rocket scientist. Actually, an aeronautical engineer. Here's Yaron. Just can't get through. Needs help. Carrazzo. So does he. And he finds it. Eddie Betts within range. Kickable shot.
Looks like he wanted to lay it off there, didn't he?
He's a bit like that number 44 at the other end. I think he likes the snap.
the trick shot. A high degree of difficulty. This is no gimme. And he pulls it. Just looked a little daunting, didn't it, for him there? Goddard, very quiet again tonight. Only five disposals for Brendan Goddard. Extraordinary, really, given the expectations.
It's a free kick to Carlton here. Yep. They had him cold. And he's just been held on to. Silly stuff.
McWalter, the villain there. And so it's Walker. Who can kick a long footy.
Just go back and be composed. What are you looking around like? I mean, just take a breath.
Ooh. He's had an up and down year. Rounds three and four, he had a total of eight disposals and no goals. Between the rest of the weeks, he kicked 13. That won't be a score. Oh, Gibbs. It was all there for him. Goddard out the back. Snyder, last possible line. Great smother. Betts likes this sort of situation. Not this time. Is that a mark? It's got to be play on, doesn't it? Everyone stopped for a moment to see what was going on. And it's going to come back, I think, to the goal square. It was kicked in too quickly.
Yes, he must indicate what score it is before the player can take off.
Thank you, Geese. Malcolm. There's Baker for St Kilda, slicing through the corridor. But Carlton had it covered. Joseph needs to get his kick. He does. Oh, Gallup, no hope there. Gwilt dropping one he should have taken. Opening the door for Gallup, who says thank you very much. You do not drop a mark when these blokes are around, Malcolm.
No.
Gee, that is a domination, isn't it, by Carlton in the clearances. 18-8. And yet they lead by just 12 points. But St Kilda wouldn't want it to get any further than that.
Fine, thanks.
As we close in on half-time.
Thanks,
David. Yaron, 17 disposals. 7 rebounds out of 50. Has been the standout for the Blues.
I've told him in, Blake's free kick.
Oh, yeah. Big man Warnock won't be happy with that.
Blake's free kick.
Jason Blake certainly will be. Outsized, but he's going to set the Saints away here. Fisher. And then we're McAvoy's deep, so is Revolt, so is Kaczynski. So all the tall timber available for a long bomb. Revolt pushes into the pocket. Another one-on-one and another one going the way of the Blue. Hello. It bubbles around for Armitage. Let's try the next two big men. Cozzy forced to spoil a fraction. Now, is that a bit overzealous, Armfield? Umpire said it was okay. Blues have wealth of numbers back there. Joseph on the way out. Be happy to find the boundary. Judge been quieter in this quarter. Nullified well by Fisher that time. And the Saints lock it up. And the Blues also play their part, making sure it doesn't go out of there.
He's only had the one touch, Hutto. Just fished up.
Is that right?
Yeah, it's an unusual quarter for him in any stage of his career.
The Blues with the numbers back in this phase of play.
Bend off, free kick, Murphy. Bend off to the face. Bend off, David.
David Armitage for getting his hand into Murphy's face. Big 3 minutes is for St Kilda. They haven't won a second quarter all year, and it's 5-2 for Carlton, 2-4 to the Saints.
They're the only team in the AFL that hasn't, Lordy.
Off hands.
Gibbs stealing the footy there. Oh, Snyder back with it. Betts coming the other way. Simpson winning it on the ground after a struggle and a clever little kick. Betts out at the edge of range. Doesn't want the shot, or does he, with the wind-up? I think that's why he didn't really want it. That's Carlton by 13.
Really, that's a panic. Just a bad spot to put it, Matthew, wasn't it?
It was.
Really bad spot.
Quickly in, but the McWalter play on and kick was not particularly good for the Saints. And they are over and out at half-back. Martin 13. One more, and Carlton would have hand in this game. You can see Thornton helping out Jamison. Warnock just dispenses with Blake that time. Small kick around the corner from Snyder.
He's better with the right than he's been doing with the left.
Cripps, Revolt and Jamison again. You can see the work that was going into Revolt by Jamison. anyone's ball now. Armfield will back his attributes, which is pace. Kept it in. Let's see if that has worked for them or not. Oh, that's a great tackle from Armitage. And opens it up for Stephen. Had plenty of options, didn't use any of them. Oh, and the fumble from Scotland at the crucial moment means that Stephen could go again. But Carlton eventually get it out of there. They're causing plenty of havoc once they can burst. And burst they will. Wait into the forward line again. Oh, Garlett. Oh, he missed that one behind. The crowd absolutely shocked. And the Saints lock it up.
Spoke of Snyder, Tim. He has been a positive, though, this quarter. As you see, the smother from Joseph. That's what he's in the team for. 17 disposals for Snyder. He's worked hard.
Gilbert climbing in, getting the tap.
Fine again. Thanks, guys.
He'd almost throw Judd now on the forward line. I mean, it's probably a bit late this quarter, but just Montagna's following around now. They're coming on off him.
Good call. He'd be tired from last week as well, Chris. Yeah. Judd.
Goddard's kick into a body that just happened to be in the wrong place for him. Scotland to Simpson, and the little dab sets up Jeffrey Garlett from 40 or a little more, and a chance to give Carlton the biggest break of the night on the brink of half-time. So this is a time to take a deep breath or two and really get it right. Very significant moment. And Garlett delivers beautifully for Carlton. His third.
As good as he is playing, Blight, and it's, as you said, he's one of your favourites. Brendan Goddard, seven disposals only for the game. What would you do with him if you're secured? Are you happy to leave him in defence?
Well, it's virtually playing on Gibbs, and Gibbs has had a fair bit of the ball. So, he's been defended. You might as well put him up forward too.
Robinson bombs away again. They are outnumbered. The Blues. Fisher. They were swirling everywhere, Carlton. But Betts will beat him for pace.
Oh, quick.
And let's see if he gets up and looks to run around.
Okay, you there?
We'll look for it. He's itching. He's itching.
He can't play on. No, the siren goes.
Hopefully for him, the siren will go. So at least he knows now that he can't.
Just hold there.
Just go back.
That's
Mark. He doesn't
closer.
What a pained look for someone who has to kick for goal.
Just kick up.
After the siren.
Stay there.
Took us to kick up.
Brendan!
What a kick it is too. He's missed. Nonetheless, Carlton lead by 20 points, taking a decisive advantage in the second quarter. They kick 6-4 to 2-4. There's no dramas heading off the ground at halftime as there was at quarter. A mountain ahead for St Kilda to climb. Going on tonight at Etihad Stadium, and late in that quarter, plenty of joyous moments for Carlton fans. The Saints have been really competitive tonight, boys. They find themselves 20 points down, and there's an old blue, Brendan Favola. Let's go to a current blue coach, in fact, and that is Brett Ratner, who's been good enough to join us. Brett, they really come hard at you tonight. What's been the most pleasing thing from your point of view?
I suppose it's how we've responded. I think that quarter time says it all, that break where where the game sits and this part of the season, I think it's really important for both teams.
And Brett, Chris Judd, just the one disposal in that second quarter, you must be pleased how the team responded without a huge influence from Judd.
Yeah, I think around the ball, I think clearances were up by about 7 or 8, something like that. And Murphy's been outstanding, which I suppose when one player's down a little bit in a quarter, someone takes a slack.
Chris Jarron's been outstanding, Brett, on the halfback. His run and carry and use has been extraordinary.
Yeah, I think he really changes the angles, and for him to get the ball into his hands, he's such a damaging player, and I think by metres he just carries the ball so much for us, so it's a huge advantage for us to get the ball in his hands.
And the Ed Curnow injury, Brett, you obviously got the all clear. He didn't look right, though, when he went back.
No, he didn't. We sort of had a look at for a couple of minutes there, and he just didn't look quite right, so we subbed him off and got Armfield into the action.
Just finally, what are you most wary of from St Kilda now into this second half?
I think it's the Rewalt-Milne influence on the game. I think them two players, I think they've had the ball in about 26 times inside their front 50, and if they keep getting that supply, those players are great players and they're never out of the game.
Thanks, Brett. Really appreciate it. Good luck.
Good on you, fellas.
Brett Ratton joining us. We do appreciate that sort of cooperation and access for the fans at home. Margin is 20 points at the moment. He's a man, obviously, that could be a dangerous one for Carl.
Yeah, Judge starting on the just interchange. The interesting thing for me is Ross Lyon's probably got to do something. Brett Ratton can just sit on his hands and sit on his 20-point lead. So I'll be looking for what maybe Ross Lyon's made some changes.
You feel, Hutto, that Orica St Kilda will have to kick 10 goals in the second half to win. I don't think Carlton will be held to under 15 goals, so they have to attack right from the first bounce.
Well, the first bounce is upon us, and then Carlton lead by 20 going into the second half.
Brett Ratton trying the old Malcolm Blight trick. He used to put Bairstow and Couch on the bench at the start of matches and start of halves, as I recall. Carlton into attack.
It was a drawing final, no less.
Yes. Yeah, that was a nice little quiet kick forward, and no one crashed in, and everyone was very civilised.
Don't like to talk about yourself, do you, Malcolm? McAvoy and Warnock. So we'll do it again. Carlton by 20. The first couple of goals of this half really crucial. St Kilda need them. If they get them, they're right back in it. Ellard getting boot to ball. Robinson, Schneider. Saints defending very hard here. Got to hold Carlton up. It slips out to Danger Man Garlett to O'Halpin. And the Irishman way off beam there, but it bounced just inside the line, so it's not the worst of results.
Brendan Goddard, no influence in the first half, is 7 disposals, starting this quarter at full forward.
It's a change. Well done.
Warnock saw the drop of the ball first there, got the tap, but McAvoy boxed on Montagna. Had to hang a long time in the air. Carrazzo, no real interest in keeping it in.
You know, Satanta, how helping then? Back to Garlett would have been the perfect play, wouldn't it? You know, with the big fella, just give and get.
Wait in the goal square with Gilbert, watching all this go on. About 30 metres, our helping. Good follow-up work. He's ready to go again. Carrazzo could have given it off to Garlett. Chose Scotland instead. Interesting kick. Walker. And here's Waite. Slipped in, slipped out, and couldn't eventually get clear. And well done to the Saints' defence. Led once again by Sam Fisher.
Had so many of those moments tonight, Jared Waite, yeah, where he's found the footy, but just...
He had that little fumble, didn't he? Just a mini fumble. Can't do it.
Gibbs got the better of Goddard with a bit of help from Dygan, but then dropped the mark. Graham. No escape from Robinson's steely tackle.
We saw Waite last week, Lordy, at the SCG. Had a really frustrating night, but he kept having a crack, didn't he, all night?
There's no doubt he'll keep doing that. Warnock and McAvoy. McAvoy to Armitage. Carlton's tackling strong.
How do you see Bryce Gibbs, Malcolm, in this stage of his career, just taking on the better players from the opposition?
Yeah, it's a great move, isn't it? I mean, he can still find the footy, and he's found the footy plenty. It's a different environment if he's going to stand at full back, though, isn't it?
It is. Warnock in good position here, getting it clear for Walker. The bounce not favouring him. So this time the boundary umpire.
He's had 15 disposals tonight, Bryce Gibbs.
Yeah, and they've been interesting disposal. I mean, he's kicked the goals, but he's also had a nice lot of contested ball.
So, all hands on deck for St Kilda. Milne's even back in defensive 50 at the moment, just slightly off behind the picture. As you can see, the scramble continues.
What Matthew said earlier at the start of this quarter was, if the Blues get another 7 or 8 goals, by doing this, St Kilda aren't going to win the game, are they? So they're going to try to break the game open somehow, somewhere.
There's swelling in there, the numbers again, the Blues. Russell, happy to just have the arm wrestle. And Melton likes it in there as well.
Getting a fair bit of practicing at bouncing these umpires, aren't they?
So still at half forward for the Blues. O'Halpin again try to work it clear. Milne down the back. Just got boot to ball. Murphy needed to kick in a hurry and did. Waite with two against him. Fisher. Never lets St Kilda down back there. The spoil was perfect.
Tim, you're right about Milne. He started this half on the wing just to get a bit of run and leg speed into the Saints.
Warnock clever to O'Halpin, and this time He misses, but scores. Touch the woodwork. Maybe touch the padding. An escape for the Saints.
Wait, Steve, wait.
Call came from Dempster out wide on the line. Wilt to himself first, and then where? Down to Revolt and Kaczynski. Tried and true method, I guess. Nick Revolt takes the mark. And they break, and here's Goddard. That's a nice little boost for him. Armitage provides some protection on the mark, and not enough protection as it turned out. But Milne did work in defence and in attack, which is where he's most deadly normally. Nice little manoeuvre from Cripps, kept it alive. Brilliant tackling, though, from Dygan, and then a bit more to go on with for Jack Stephen.
It's where they've improved this year, the Blues, their defence. That wasn't on last year. They were easy to score against, and they're a new outfit in defence now. McAvoy down to Schneider. Where to go from here? The fumble didn't help. And, the ball might have hung over the line, and umpire McBurney will ball it up.
Mid-zone, you take in.
Carlton winning the clearances 2-1. Warnock bringing it down carefully. Carlton's turn now to defend and try and choke St Kilda. Judd getting ready. McAvoy, Warnock, Robinson just blazing. That can be dangerous. Graham and Simpson, Revolt, Goddard, made a mess of it between them. Simpson, a cool customer, releases Scotland.
Who goes for a helping, who's getting plenty of it at the moment. His usage has been in question. Needs to get it right this time. It looks good in flight. And Jared Waite takes the mark. And he's within range here. And he pretty much turned his back on everyone else initially, thinking that he could go the journey. He must have his doubts now. He's settled, and he goes for it. And McAvoy got there right at the death. So they creep up to a 22-point margin now, the Blues. And a full forward flirtation didn't last too long for Brendan Goddard, it seems.
His last couple of kicks have been into other players' bodies. This time he goes the journey, but Revolt, not for the first time this year, had more than one man against him.
Look what he might do, is just play all over the ground, just get carte blanche, run around.
Lots of physical attention. So the Blondes can kill the leader. Warnock down to Scotland. Back to Warnock. Lobbing it. Walker went the trot. Gilbert's free kick.
Made the mark, actually, Tim.
See the chop. Not sure that I saw the mark, but it is six of one and a half a dozen of the other. St Kilda would take either a six or a half dozen on the scoreboard right now. Here's Revolt. Stephen, quiet night. Now Revolt sees targets in the corridor. Missed Baker. Could be dangerous. Might work yet. Gilbert through the middle. Promising move. Kaczynski well covered by Thornton. Gilbert kept coming. Now, one-on-one. Goddard and Gibbs. Gibbs! Oh, what a victory that was.
Indeed it was, and it could be the springboard here for the Blues. Or Murphy overcommitted, and he got out of jail and kicks quickly. And look at them line up, and they're all over the top. I helped, and no one is going near him at the moment. It was a pretty good kick from Joseph. It brought him into a much better angle. And Satanta didn't get over-ambitious. He passed it off. And Simpson... oh, got himself into trouble. He's got to go back to a helping again. And the law of averages perhaps would seem that he would eventually kick one, but not so. Graham.
Crucial.
Montagna, it was. We'll see how crucial in a moment. Goddard at least starting to get a feel for it now. Had second thoughts after. Was going to go for a revolt. Brings it into McWalter. Blues defence trying to get organised. They've got a wealth of numbers on this side, St Kilda. If they happened to bring it on the fan and on a different avenue, they didn't. They went down the middle. And Carlton had them covered there. And they're just trying to cool things off a bit here, the Blues, I think, and just regain their composure at half-back. The margin remains at 22.
Both teams have been really wasteful. St Kilda 5-8, Carlton 8 goals, 12.
Good fella.
Carlton are spreading once again like this.
Helfand's still on his own, pretty much at full forward, so St Kilda not worrying about him at all.
A hanging ball from Warner, but it got to Robinson. Corazzo feeding to Dygan, to Armfield. Funny little kick, made it tough for Satanta, who's Captain Calamity at the moment. And he gets the result. No, Betts not quite. Touched in flight, so the ball up.
Are they butchering some chances or what?
We send you down to check those balls. You might be right.
I did talk about the left and right-handed footballs a few years ago, but we won't go there, Matthew.
I think Bet's saying that he picked it up. The umpire's saying, no, you didn't. St Kilda work it away.
Helfand's had seven touches for the corner. Three only effective. Dygan to Yaron. If anyone's going to kick it in amongst the confusion, it'd be him. But even he can't find a target. Del Santo came up a little sore after that spoil. But the goal was achieved. And we'll have a throw-in in the pocket. Carlton continuing to press. One more here would really make the Saints' job tough. Joseph through, hands of Corazzo. Simpson barges his way through. Good work, Milne. Clever stuff from Russell. Armfield into the goal square. And Fisher again to save the day, as he has so many times before. Off to Gwilt, who was trying to tempt Riewoldt into really running for him hard on the wing, but Riewoldt realised it was going to be too tough. So now Gwilt has to think again.
Long ball, Goddard, Gibbs just shunting him a little. Montagna crumbing it, touched off the boot. Krzyzewski beaten by Riewoldt. Gibbs passed it by Yaron. Armfield, Thornton. Just a look away, hand pass, a blind hand pass. Lets the Saints in. Schneider's kick good. Now, Riewoldt, this is the moment. He must deliver something for St Kilda.
And what he's done, he's just covered about 100 metres flat out. So he's actually sucking them in. And that's one of the problems, of course, when you run that far and run that hard. Now to compose and kick it correctly.
It is a good point, and it's been 9 inside 50s to 2 in favour of Carlton. And Carlton just kicked the 2 points for all that work in the 11 minutes. So this would be a huge moment in the game if Riewoldt can kick this, but he has struggled once again with his kicking tonight.
Been such a struggle, they've defended for their lives.
Oh, shocking kick from Riewoldt. He is in trouble psychologically.
Hard to watch, isn't it? It's a champion like this really struggling
and missing by a margin like that.
Gee, Robinson, a bold kick, maybe a foolish kick. Milne almost over the shoulder. Scotland, they were right on the precipice of giving away an easy shot there, the Blues. They still might, but they are full of confidence at the moment. Corazzo and Scotland maybe overconfident. Betts goes back in after it. So eventually they've worked their way out. Robinson, a high ball. Where's Satanta? Not there this time. It's Jones.
No, he's having a rest at the moment, Hutto.
That's the only way Carlton can make sure that he doesn't get it again.
And some space for Armitage. Hanging ball. Carlton with all the crumbing power here. Wait to Yaron. Just couldn't slip through. A desperation tackle from Sam Gilbert. His rugby league background coming to the fore there. Still the Blues come. Judd back from the bench, but he overshot. And that was a good spoil by Gwilt.
Another butchered kick.
And here's that last set shot from Nick Riewoldt. Remember early in the year he had his head right over the footy? Well, it's not as prominent, so the technique has changed.
Graham rested away. Got some help from Blake. And they're to the wing. Bit of a mismatch in size there, but fighting out of his weight division. Simpson, he's used to that. And he does it effectively, and he draws the plaudits to the Blues fans. And Cripps is a bit sore there as he comes off for some remedial work. The margin still stands at 22. This game very much on the edge as far as St Kilda is concerned. Carlton, I guess, not too worried if it stays around about this level. They'd certainly love to add an extra. Is that in the back on Goddard, or is it holding the ball? Neither, says the umpire.
Tell you what, it's been willing, there's nothing else.
And Judd still the only one disposal in this third quarter as well. And here's the injury to Cripps just being landed on there. Yeah.
Just his knee, Lordy. They're just trying to walk it off at the moment.
Hurry kick from Armitage. The turnovers can really cruel you. Jamison just got it away in time. Kick from Dygan. Really didn't help Murphy too much. Didn't get the bounce he needed, but he was able to adjust. Scotland off the left. Now, Joseph's kick, a real up and under. Allard had allowed Goddard some air, and he did well to kill the contest. But McGralter, he was gone. And the Blues can go Nick forward. Dygan's and again, free. It's the tackling pressure of Nick Dygan.
Waiting for the right moment, the right target. Wait is that target.
There's enormous pressure on St Kilda at the back, hasn't there? But they just can't quite get the goal.
And I just want to ask you, Murray, I feel like Judd's labouring. He's coming off the ground again. How have you seen his running tonight?
Yeah, no, flat tonight, Lordy. I reckon he's been worked over really hard by the St Kilda taggers. And it was such a monumental effort from him last week in difficult conditions.
Jared Waite didn't make the distance from a little further out. This time he nails it. That's the big one.
So one of the key indicators these days, the time in forward half, for this quarter, as we have seen quite clearly with our eyes, been dominated by the Blues. Haven't got reward for that until now. Not Pretty the best cool. work of by Vozzo there, and we'll have another ball up. For the match, Carlton have had it 58% in the forward half. O'Helpin has a run in the ruck now. That's a better place for him to be launching from. Waits out on the 50 with Gwilt. Gilbert the backup.
The loss of Lenny Hayes once again tonight. 28 clearances to 15, Whitey.
Yeah, no, he's a big loss, isn't he? Armitage is doing okay. He's improving, isn't he?
Yes, but just his foot skills, Armitage, compared to Hayes.
Great tackling from Robinson. Latched on. That was just a fraction over the top.
Let him up, Mark.
Against Murphy. Tackle. And it goes to Montagna. His 16th disposal, skipping away from half-back and hitting Nick Riewoldt. So promising build-up here for the Saints.
They're running for him, and he delivers it well to Schneider, who should be able to kill this, and he does. The Saints pull one back.
Believe it or not, that's their first score for 28 minutes, St Kilda. At least Schneider kicked straight. Last week, there was a real problem. The margin of 22 points is restored. Still O'Helpin in the ruck. And it's Mitch Robinson getting them going this time. Joseph has been redeployed into the forward line. Scooped it up to Judd. May not have had the impact over the game, but boy, when he does, he's a sight to behold. He misses. I think the Carlton fans have quite realised it yet. Just the four contested possessions tonight for Judd. He was trying his hardest to will it back, and the margin is at 23.
23 is gettable.
Yep.
Important reply by Schneider a moment ago. Just St Kilda's third goal kicker of the night. Again, Sam Fisher's hands are receptive. Jones for Riewoldt again, hitting up to the middle of the ground. Graham, St Kilda starting to put it together. Kuzicki the sit. And well, he sat too firmly in position and seemed to forget about the drop of the ball. Dygan just crabbing sideways, waiting to Gibbs, to Russell. Gibbs, their defence working well together. Robinson, ball hanging, but Judd strong. And the Blues now look to build another attack. The call comes from Allard.
So just a little fraying around the edges. Judd with the up and under. It's turned out beautifully for them. It left a lot of space for Waite. Again, he's on the brink here. Doesn't go for goal. Instead, probably wishes he did right now because it sets Stephen and Gwilt and the Saints away again into the clear middle. And he committed himself to playing on. So he's forced to handball. Now, got options if Riewoldt looked back. He might have seen... Oh, Sipos up high. Didn't take the mark, but still might create a goal. And it does... Cripps puts it through.
Nick Riewoldt, he's really stood up. I know he's missed targets, but he has absolutely blown Jamieson up. He cannot run with him anymore. That's the fifth mark for Riewoldt. Jamieson, just the one touch this quarter. He's creating a lot. Set up the last two goals, Nick Riewoldt.
The football has been so attritional in this quarter in particular that it's possible
that this game could take an unpredictable direction. Here's Simpson for Carlton. On whom will the battle toll wear greater? Here's Robinson escaping, but missing big time.
It's a good point, Tim, because we've seen a lot of footy played that way, haven't we? Where the late in the third and into the last, things can change dramatically.
And the three rules still applies, Tim.
And we're within the range.
Exactly.
We're right on it.
Right on it.
Goddard, Montagna.
Oh, there he is.
And the Saints at half back, and with a bit of overlap and maybe some confidence restored. Jones, high ball. Sipoff waits out the back, and he's got the grab. Okay. Gets some directions from his teammates. And he just keeps on running and running. And he cuts the kick across. Very smart for Cripps. Blues defence was onto it, though. Scotland, clever, out to Waite. He tries to decipher the best method of getting it forward.
He's worked hard, Jared Waite, but he's had five clangers tonight. Just made some horrible decisions.
Oh! Jamieson. Oh, got out of that somehow.
Whoops.
And again, a hurried, unscientific kick out to the wing where Goddard drew the free.
Just wonder how much last week's win took out of the side as a whole. And they have lifted the Saints.
Just about to say that, Lordy, down at ground level, you get a real sense that Carlton's really flattened off here.
Interchange infringement here. Now, which way does it go?
It's against Carlton. It's against Carlton. Oh, boy.
Well, they've butchered the ball going forward, Matthew. That's as simple as it has been.
They have.
You can't work that hard and give it up six or seven times like they have and think you're going to be a good team.
Couldn't agree more. The boot's on the other foot tonight as at a crucial time. An interchange decision goes against Carlton, and Brendan Goddard has the chance to cut the margin to 12 points.
Yeah, 2 metres.
Just the three goals too as we watch interchange infringement.
Andrew, just no closer. 2 metres.
Hard to judge there, but this man hasn't been kicking as well this year. Needs to kick well now, and he does. It is absolutely perfect. The Saints are back in town.
So here's another look at what we think happened.
That went too early, you think, for Robinson?
I was in half a step, if that's. If it was.
Margin back to 12. And the Blues, Chris Judd has tried to single-handedly keep their position, their dominance here in this corner after being quiet in the second. Hasn't been able to achieve it. The Saints are swarming forward again, as Lloydy said. Revolt's been a key link in the chain. Montagna, great delivery for Milne. And they're buzzing everywhere, the Saints. And Carlton fans know it.
The centre clearance, Lloydy.
Yeah, why would Carlton attempt five little handballs like that in tight, not quick forward? I mean, I just don't understand that. Once you get the ball, hands on the ball in the middle, unless it's on, kick it.
And Montagna, he just belted it forward, got it back again, and a good finish to Milne.
So Stephen Milne with three goals, one tonight. Ooh, didn't like the strike. And McAvoy's mark came a little too late. The margin, though, cut to 11. If they do lose tonight, that is going to sum up a lot of their angst. They've missed some crucial shots at goal. I know Carlton have as well.
They're not thinking losing at the moment. They are playing some inspired footy from an almost beaten position. It was 28 points into the second half of this quarter. Gibbs kick hugging the line out on the full. The Saints will come again. Another one, Malcolm.
Yeah.
Plenty of scoring time left in the quarter yet. Wilt with that searching left boot. It's a good ball in the McAvoy direction. Just too far out, you would think. Got it off, got it back.
Yours.
Even further out now. Here comes Goddard. Oh, brave Robinson coming with the flight. Gibbs to Armfield, to Robinson. Carlton with the one extra on the overlap. Now to Yaron. Not quite as influential in this quarter. Back to Robinson, running into trouble. And a hard nut in Baker. Gilbert for St Kilda. Armitage to Graham. Saints indomitable at the moment. McAvoy again. 65 out. Cut off by Thornton.
Ambition and ability mixed up a bit there.
The Blues want to slow it down here. But they have to be careful not to be too negative in their mindset. Wait takes the mark at centre-half back. You mentioned Yaron's influence, Tim, but also Betts and Garlett. They've only had one disposal each for the quarter.
Yeah, but mainly because they haven't been kicked at or kicked to. I mean, all the bad kicking's gone to other players.
Scotland. It's harder to do this these days than it ever was because of the press. As teams close on you, just the chipping stuff is difficult. It's hard to get the footy when you're on the bench, Eddie. So he goes the bomb. Long down the line. Oh, Satanta didn't have the influence he would have liked there, and Wilt takes the mark. They are hard to pass at the moment. The St Kilda defence. Deep goes the kick. Sipos happy to fly for it. Stephen doing what small men do in the forward line, and that is Shark. Couldn't get it cleanly. It's over and out, but it's 11 points here at Etihad with only a minute and a half remaining.
Keep saying it. Big phase. Big 90 seconds here. Two ruckmen there for the Saints.
Yours.
Quick kick, Russell. Montagna. Judd there with him. Ploughing in. Good ball up. Carlton wanting to hold here and not let St Kilda go in with another goal on the board. A tremendous psychological boost. Del Santo the swat. Judd smothered. Goes back in. Carrazzo missing. Joseph. Armfield topped it high from Ralph Clark. St Kilda subs on.
High. Back here.
Carlton's ball. Cripps out of the game. Ralph Clark into it for St Kilda.
Oh, another dodgy looking kick. We just saw the replay there. Scotland marks, spots Dygan. And the Blues. St Kilda man on man there, Hutto, all around the ground. And they're feeling it here. Dygan just has to go for distance. Any marking targets? No, not at all for the Blues. And that was easy fodder for Sam Fisher. He's been doing that for 10 years. Takes the grab. Carlton's lead is 11. Fisher gets some timely cramp. And maybe that was genuine. He kicked it out on the floor.
No, it's a bad footy, Matty. It's got to be.
I hope so.
I reckon it's the left side. They're all going left, aren't they? Left-sided footy.
Now, to Carlton try and score here. They've got the footy, but they're behind the wing. Time for either team. Simpson floating it in. Fisher there again. At the back, Waite a chance, but closing on him is Jones. Waite, useful kick. Oh, Halpin is within range. Anything could happen here.
He's played on.
He has, and he's managed to miss it. There's always a new way for Satanta.
I hate to say, he's had a very good quarter, but he's turned it over, hasn't he?
Yes, but there has been, as we spoke about, and Murray were talking about it with Carlton, some tired boys out there. How this last quarter plays out, you think Carlton are the quicker side, but it's played on St Kilda's terms, this game at the moment.
So only a calamity would result in a scoring chance here, or maybe a late grab. Oh, almost from Judd. So siren will sound. Saints made some inroads in that quarter. They kicked 3-1 to 1-5. Carlton would be ruining the fact, boys, that St Kilda had the door open. But well played, St Kilda.
It was 9 inside 52 at the start of the quarter for Carlton. They blew their chances, just kicking the one. And that plays on in St Kilda's hands, and they won that second part. Revolt looks in good touch.
Are they back, St Kilda? The emotion in the face of Brendan Goddard. He believes. For you at home, we'll find out next. A quarter to go on Monday Night Footy. What a night for Ross Lyon. What a night to be in the coach's box when there's so much at stake. Just one win so far this year. This one is now there for the taking. They're 12 points behind at three-quarter time. You can see how much it means to a man who's enjoyed so much success as the coach, but has still eluded him. The big one, of course. There's how it stands at three-quarter time. It's the Blues 9:15. Five of those behinds have been rushed for Carlton. St Kilda 8:9:57. Lloydy, a couple of things you want to talk about.
Yeah, look at the body language at three-quarter time. The Saints all running in. Carlton in dribs and drabs. And then after that, an altercation between a couple of Carlton players. Satantro Halpin and Brett Thornton. Watch this at three-quarter time. Thornton maybe questioning the decision-making and maybe that last shot even of Satantro Halpin, and he didn't like it. And Justin Cordy, the fitness coach, having to restrain the two of them. So Brett Thornton should consider himself lucky that Satantro didn't get him on the deck and stow the boot in. Exactly right. So it's interesting. St Kilda still in their huddle. Carlton are out. And I reckon St Kilda would enjoy the position where they're in. Obviously, they've got to kick some goals, but it's in a scrap how they like it.
Let's go down to Murray.
It was a completely different scene in the St Kilda camp, Hutto. They were full of buzz and fizz at three-quarter time. Ross Lyon called them all in. He gave them some really clear instructions before they broke into their groups. And lo and behold, it was Stephen Milne in the middle of it all saying, we've got these blokes. We're all over them. We're all over them. You can delete the expletives because there were plenty of those thrown in as well. But the little man who's been the live wire so far tonight clearly believes, and he can feel it, as Lordy alluded to, with about 10 minutes to go, that St Kilda's got all the run in the legs and the Carlton boys are flat. So they believe they can win this, St Kilda.
Thank you, Andy.
Last quarter coming up in the great tradition of Monday Night Football.
Sam Fisher brilliant on Jeff Garlett. Kept him to one disposal. Bit of a mismatch there, but it was too big and strong. You feel Betts and Garlett have got something in them in this last quarter. Your call on Jamison and Revolt could have been a telling one in that third quarter, Lloyd. He's worked him up the ground, so it'll be interesting to see what Jamison's got left in those legs. Last quarter underway. Warnock with a decisive-looking tap. Snyder's been good coming in off the wing tonight. Had 19 disposals. Jarden, Warnock and Murphy sorted out. It's clean out of the middle. It's in quick. Defenders don't like that. Walker couldn't quite get it. Garlett itching to get after it again. His mate Betts beat him to it. And chipping ball is just astray. So, the margin now is 13.
Hold Andrew, no
time. Got him one goal four, Eddie. He's just been astray with his snap, hadn't he? He's had a couple of shots.
The game on a similar course to St Kilda's last outing in Adelaide when they were five goals down at half-time. Got back in the third quarter, but didn't go on. Tonight, looking to do that. Armitage, good mark from the kick-in. Revolt again coming a long way up ground. Jamison with him. Gibbs the crumb. And a clever kick to the 50. Schneider the crumber, though, for the Saints. Caught on his wrong side. Del Santo, another. Molly Duca. Long ball in the Goddard direction. And McAvoy, big mark. Montagna, first goal here is crucial. If the Saints get it, they'll be hard to stop, and they might get it here because that man Milne will be lining them up. What'll he do? Often plays on, but this is a very kickable set shot. Three goals in the opening quarter, hasn't added to it. For the 449th of his career, he's had plenty of practice, and he cashes in on it. Look away now, if you're a bit queasy, look at this, Jamison at the start of the third, at the fourth quarter. That's what Nick Riewoldt does to opponents. Nine marks now, 16 disposals. He's worked him over.
It hasn't been this close since late in the second quarter. And the Saints know it. Montagna, they worked it out of the middle again. Schneider, they've gone back first to go forward now. Fisher's short ball, read well in the air by Murphy, but he lost his footing. That was telling. Armitage, Dempster, they're deep again. McAvoy's already taken four contested marks tonight. Couldn't add to it there. He's been an important link in the chain, McAvoy, Lloydie.
He has been, and Warnock hasn't offered a lot around the ground, just the 10 disposals. McAvoy's marked really well.
So 7 points the margin now. And the Blues defence under stress and strain. Armfield, oh, fastened the kick straight to Dempster. The fumble proved crucial. Montagna, Blues careful not to give away the free. Ball buzzing around. Snyder loves it in that situation. He's worked it onto the boot. It is through for another one. They are back.
Well, we saw O'Halpin and Thornton at three-quarter time, Lordy and Blighty, and
We just saw then when they couldn't clear the footy, Simpson turned around to Jared Waite and gave him a bake, and Waite had to come over and explain what was going on. They're starting to do a lot of finger pointing out there at the moment, the Blues.
Saints have kicked the last five goals. It's cliche to talk of season-defining games, but that's what we face here for St Kilda and perhaps for Carlton.
Thanks. And for the Saints, it's about the 4 points as well, isn't it? They really need the points, not just to have their season back on track with the confidence from a win.
Got to find a 50-50 and get it forward quickly, Carlton.
Blake, the better of O'Halpin there. Important free kick. St Kilda's way. The forces with them. Jones on the break. High into the 50. Dygan, though, an old head, despite the fact that he's a first-season player. Played on, gave to Jamison, to Yaron. And Carlton now must really steady itself. Coming off a hard-earned win in Sydney, so the Blues have been in the crucible recently. Thornton, but they're getting the fiddles down the back. Russell for Dygan again. Won't have too many options here. Does have Garlett. Carlton look to build. Garlett to a contest, in fact missing the contest. Murphy overrunning it. Gilbert, all scooping it up to Armitage. Dempster, Saints though coolly work it around to the coolest hand in town. Fisher to Raph Clark, bad miss. Waite with him, getting him off it. And Waite has support behind him in Judd. The Carlton skipper needing to execute well. Walker needed the cleanest of hands. The delay cost him. Gilbert the smother. And it's not happening for the Blues.
Good work there from Waite. Made a few mistakes tonight, but when they need someone to stand up, that was a really important play.
Warnock against nobody there, but he tapped it straight to Del Santo, who gave it straight back up to Gibbs. They look around for something to come. What was that from Jared Waite? Might work out okay. Judd to the right, Judd to the left. And guess who's going to have the shot for goal, everybody? Satanta.
Oh, he's due, isn't he? He's found the footy.
What was that from Jared Waite?
I think he's been watching Satanta.
He must have been. So what an indifferent night it's been. Of course, Satanta O'Halpin couldn't help but find the footy in that third quarter. And his team needs him now. Needs him to kick straight. I guess, as I said, the law of averages means he'll get it right eventually. And he does when it matters most. Blues by 7.
An enthralling struggle, and that was one of the more unpredictable twists. O'Halpin kicking the goal to give Carlton some breathing space. He and McAvoy, St Kilda's number one ruckman. O'Halpin, Carlton's number two. Armitage quick kick, Dygan first two. It's shunted by Stephen. Well played, Dygan. Carrazzo, Robinson, Simpson on his wrong side. Just needed to kick and hope. The bouncing ball, Walker, the swat. Scotland, cool player. Robinson back to Armfield, getting a call and delivering, and good strong hands for the Blues from another unlikely man up front named Aaron Joseph.
Just the 6 goals in Aaron Joseph's career in his 47 games. So like O'Halpin, unlikely source for goal.
What's his odds?
I'd say 50%.
So you're being a little bit kind, but you never know. Oh, it is full!
You'd have to say 50% is a pretty accurate summation there, wouldn't you?
There's Warnock. He's been run off his legs by McAvoy. McAvoy's got on top. They've had to move Warnock to full forward. O'Halpin's now taking the ruck.
Wilt looks for Kaczynski to come up over the top. Judd's got his eye on it as well. Mark has to go to the man in front. Been good to see him clunk a few of those tonight. Del Santo sneaking past. I have to think carefully here. Well done to Carlton. Just to hold it up, stop them in their tracks, keep the ball in their forward half, and a rueful look from Nick Del Santo. 8 points the diff. Mark Murphy has got some close attention tonight from Clint Jones, 20 disposals for Murphy. McAvoy high again. Del Santo, that's good yardage. Nicely chopped off by Dygan. He decides to switch. Happy to trust. Oh, help, and oh, the crowd could see Milner's about to lay a big tackle on Allard. Got it safely to Joseph. No tall targets deep for the Blues. He'll know that. Sneaks it into the pocket instead, hoping the little man can do the job. Goddard ducked his head. The umpire was onto him there. Ball wasn't locked underneath
him. Ball came out. Duck your head, Brendan.
There you go. Ball up.
Eddie.
Yeah, I wish when they duck, they turn. It's dangerous, that.
So it's the Blues by 8 points, and the ball is in their 50. And the tackling is fierce, and the stakes are high. More than half a quarter left. Stirring revival from the Saints. Warnock, Judd couldn't break through. Gibbs, never balanced. St Kilda's ball.
Stay there.
So it's over to Clint Jones. Margin still at 8. Is there a way out? Kaczynski is a good option tonight from what we've seen. He gets involved again, can't take the mark. Poked back by Goddard, back to McAvoy. Gibbs looks and sees that Milne was sneaking through, and it's over and out. McAvoy and Warnock crossing swords again. Heavy engagement between the two of them. Montagna can't escape, can't keep his feet. Allard, Carrazzo, the instant handballs. Worked all right initially for the Blues, but there's just no space to work in. Very tough working conditions. That's deliberate against Jason Graham. So it's Chris Judd's footy. We'll see what the Saints fans think about that. Let's have another look.
That's fair enough. So much on the line. It's a 12-minute ball game for the Saints season here. Judd hoping someone can snare a mark. Blake the spoil, the crumb. Robinson had a moment of opportunity. Garlett, star in the first half, swept away there. Jones hand pass to no one. Dygan been very good in this last quarter. Russell, Warnock there. McAvoy, crucial spoil. Warnock hoping for Simpson. Hot contest. Gilbert in there. Betts in there. Umpire comes in.
It's good.
It is good, buddy. There is so much at stake, and you just feel like St Kilda playing their best footy for a long time.
Vacant goal square here for the Blues. If they can get it clear, Saints push a few numbers back now, just in case. What's the ruling on that play on? Baker, copping it from all angles. The umpire, impossible to see what's going on there.
Right, ball came out.
Is it Carlton played? Dygan in all sorts of trouble on in many different ways by the look of that.
Just threw up there, so he's just been punched in the stomach. He should be okay in 5 or 10 minutes.
Not sure he's got 10 minutes, Lloydie.
11 to go. Just, he's been one of their better defenders too, so he should be right. Yeah.
He's had 4 contested possessions this quarter. The margin's still at 8, and the game's still on a knife edge.
He's held Carlton's back half together, really, in this last turn. Del Santo, high ball. Revolt arriving. Russell there too. Scotland for Carlton.
Oh, back here as he kicks.
It's coming back. It's a Carlton free.
Back up there.
Not for a late tackle, but for a high tackle.
Sam, kick it back up there.
Carlton fans, I think, are booing because they thought it would be relayed. But it was on the disposal. So it's a correct call by Michael Vozzo, as you can see.
There's, free kick St Kilda.
Oh, it's a free kick against Carlton.
Hit him in the stomach.
Against Warnock.
So St Kilda's ball, crucial turnaround. Ralph Clark to take it.
Wilt limps off the ground for St Kilda. Dempster just on, screaming for it on the wing. More direct is the approach. Jamison again in Revolt almost. McWalter, that'll do. Heaves it inside 50. Anyone's footy. Anyone who wants it, that is. And Russell's been outstanding. Yaron still creative by hand, even under the pump. Simpson comes away, uses Armfield. Now Judd. Carlton fans to their feet. Big ball to be won at centre-half forward. Saints have the numbers. They're all tall timber back there for them. Blake and Fisher and McAvoy combined. They're not out yet, though. It was unwieldy. It was under pressure. And it could go anyway. Garlett stalking. He and Joseph there for the Blues. And Blake, using all the guile and experience possible, somehow wills the ball over the line. And everyone's enjoying Monday night footy.
It is stirring stuff. Warnock and McAvoy, Judd scouting. Can he get the strike he needs? He can't.
Change, Ross.
And Carlton's lead is 9 points, a kick and a half, with just over half the quarter left. Got time to set up. Tired players. They've just got to keep the ball in their forward half.
Judd up to 23 disposals, boys. So he's been big since half-time. Del Santo, low ball, dangerous stuff. Robinson terrific with his effort. Oh, got Jones high. Umpire didn't see it. Crowd didn't have the view that we did. Robinson goes in again. It's relentless stuff.
You just spoke of Robinson, Hutto. Look at this. Efforts like that, 74% in the forward half compared to the Saints 26. So they keep this up. They win the game.
Tired bodies out there.
Saints have kicked 2-1 against that percentage. Yeah. Oh, little shee.
Couple of hooks in there.
Good call, Hutto. Warnock, McAvoy, Murphy at the ruckman's feet. Good tackle by Graham. Knock on by Sipos.
Tackle here, Andrew Carrazzo.
Charlton's ball.
Lee, the mark's here.
Carrazzo's footy with 70 from home. Hoisting and hoping. Warnock is there, but so's big boy McAvoy. The big second half.
He has. How's he going to use it here, though? You always get nervous when a ruckman has to kick delicately. A chopping of the arms.
Stay out.
Baker with the ball. Still on the last line, pretty much. Now it's out for the Saints. To Jones. He decides to accelerate away and go for a revolt with Milne there for the change. It doesn't go his way, though. Thornton sorted it out. And what a great leader Russell's been tonight for Carlton. No mark at half forward, no free kick. And it's a ball up.
Gee, the two ruckmen have just come off, Warnock and McAvoy. Oh, absolutely stuffed. I've never seen two tired blokes.
No, he's gone, Barney. He's absolutely got nothing left, big Robbie Warnock.
So it's over to Kaczynski, you know, helping. And it was Cozzy who grabbed it.
McAvoy's been the big winner there. 5 contested marks, 15 disposals. Warnock, only the 2 marks and 11 disposals.
41,500 the crowd.
About the same as last year on Monday night when these teams met. Same weekend. Simpson trying to streak through. Now a tug of war. O'Halpin and Murphy getting it out of there for Carlton. But Jones read it well. And St Kilda break. Blake feeding. Fisher lobbing. The line would be a great result. But it's sat. And it's sat for Scotland, whose kick isn't great. Nothing there for Carlton. Schneider, Jones, and that might be in the back. The umpire's letting a lot go. And Mitch Robinson, a man who appreciates latitude. But now it's St Kilda's ball as they will start a build-up in search of one of at least 2 goals they need.
And Graham was given an inch, took a mile. Thornton in front, no free kick, no mark. Blues stand firm again, or do they? Yaron in cruise control. Tempting and luring his teammates to go where he wanted them to go, they obeyed. Murphy takes the mark.
Wonderful non-panicking, wasn't it? Just cool as a cucumber.
Non-panicking.
A bit like Andrew McLeod. Reminded me of.
Murphy, a wobbly one to the wing. Clark, Robinson, all had a piece of it. Gilbert found a way. McWalter, they've set up. It's complete. And the delivery was perfect too. And Sipos on debut. He's a beautiful kick of the footy normally, and that is a great kick for a young man. It's a goal.
See, on the goal line. Good shepherding there from Milne.
I thought you were supposed to look at the ball.
That's okay. On the goal line, Blighty, you can do whatever you want. We should know that by now.
But well done. The ruling might be that he wasn't trying to mark. And so, therefore, was open to the shepherd within 5 metres. Anyway, it's irrelevant. Aaron Sipos, St Kilda's youngest debutant since Brendan Goddard in 2003. 18 years, 165 days. And he's kicked a goal to give St Kilda hope. They're within a kick. It's more than hope. It's belief. Simpson giving it off. Russell under the pump. Somehow disposed. Carrazzo having to blaze without knowing where he was going. And it gives St Kilda the upper hand. Schneider feeding. Too strong for Del Santo. Armitage slipping Scotland. Dempster, brilliant smother for Carlton from Ellard. Keeping it alive now. And now not quite knowing where to go. Murphy, Carlton under fierce pressure. St Kilda back from the grave tonight. Fisher hustled off it. Betts getting it out, but straight to Del Santo. And the Saints are on the build. The skipper's got it.
And they're ready for more. Del Santo, 10th disposal of this final term. He had to look wide, and he found Blake, who wanders through the middle of the ground, digs as deep as he can, and kicks it as deep as he can. And Steigen knew it was coming. He took it. Now the Blues can reload. Out to halfback. It's in good hands. It was out of those hands for a moment, Yaron. And as a result, he turned it over. But not for long. Gibbs around the corner. Carlton haven't been able to get it past centre-half forward for the last 10 minutes. And they'll go again through Armitage. They're coming of age, the younger Saints. Was that a free? No, not paid by the umpire. Oh, and the Blues defence, they dodge a bullet there. Simpson through the middle, overwhelmed by numbers though. Yaron to Judd. Who else can he get through? He got help. Eddie Betts with one. Eddie Betts, long kick, full forward, and Fisher.
Oh, this is a pulsating game. The umpires have absolutely put the whistle away. Surely that was a free kick to Milne within range. Here's Jones to Kuzietzki. Still the force seems to be with the Saints. Revolt picks it up low down. 5.5 minutes. A heap of time. What tension. Season's on the line. At least one anyway. It's not a great placement. Brett Thornton's decision making sometimes questioned. Takes a conservative route here to Yaron. Fresh from his first mistake, I think it's fair to say, of the evening. Umpire calls time, says you've got to go. So he goes long. Revolt is there. So are quite a few others.
Chris Judd, 8 disposals in this last quarter, 4 contested possessions. You feel he's trying to work himself in after a disappointing first half.
There goes the throw in. Graham tries to get amongst it. Dempster. Judd. Kuzietzki comes out. Comes out again. Armitage, Del Santo. Starting to cut them up. Milne's the man to watch if he goes deep. Oh, he went too deep perhaps. At least it was lofted. Gave McWalter a chance. And it's in there. And that's the most important thing. It'll give them the opportunity. We've reached the last 5 minutes. And the tension is unbearable here.
Someone's going to be very happy at the end of this game. One team.
McAvoy the tap. Deigen. Goddard. Graham. Jason Graham. Saints in front. Saints alive.
Seven of the last 8 goals, the Saints.
Yeah, they've played in the last 2 grand finals for a reason.
First time they've been in front for 77 minutes, and they've grabbed the lead in the last 5 minutes of the match. Judd's quick kick finds Betts. Still virtually in the centre. He has a man loose, and it is Scotland. Might have been tempted to play on, but I think he's made the right call. The problem for him is that the distance on fourth quarter legs is too much. He gives to Judd. Question of making good decisions here and then executing. And even the champion skills can let him down under heat like this. St Kilda have won 12 of their last 13 against Carlton. And against the odds, they might win a 13th here, and Revolt arrives. He's lifted heroically. When it's had to be prized back, he has worked his opponent over. It doesn't show on his personal score chart, but he's played a part. Long ball, Dempster there going to ground. Important ball. Milne knocking it to the line.
At mark number 12 for Nick Revolt. 19 disposals, working back towards a 50 once again.
The margin is 3 in St Kilda's favour. They have really dominated play of late. Gibbs around the corner. This is where it's fallen down continually, though, for Carlton. And on one leg, Sam Fisher takes the mark. 20 disposals, 10 marks for Sam Fisher. For Montagna, they are in no hurry now. Time is on their side all of a sudden. Roles reversed here. The Blues, who led by as much as 28, have seen it gradually eroded by this resilient St Kilda side. Carrazzo, Armfield, where to? That's probably the best thing to do where the numbers are. Keep it short and keep it moving. Robinson, now they've got a framework out wide. They can use it. Dygan, it's all ahead of him. No definitive target yet. Wait, working overtime to provide that. And there's the contest. No mark, free kick.
Free kick.
Okay. So deep is Walker, deep is Betts.
And deep is all the St Kilda players working as hard back as any team.
So he has to go short, and he does. Robinson rolls the dice into the pocket, and there's Walker.
Sam.
Wow.
Get good.
And there's pressure.
Andrew Walker has had 8 disposals tonight. They've all been kicks. He's kicked 1 goal straight. Was a defender. Now's the chance to prove his bona fides as a forward. We all know the pressure. And how's he coped with it? That's how. That's how he's coped with it. Carlton back in front. But it ain't over yet. Don't take it off.
One of the mysteries of footy, isn't it? Yeah.
Great couple of minutes there for Mitch Robinson. The roll-off, when the numbers, like Bonnie said, were rolling back, he went. Walker, a fit player, and a big kick for a man who's been maligned for his goal-kicking. What a game we've had tonight. And Lordy, Carlton's just taken Walker off and thrown. They'll help him back to be the extra man in defence.
Carlton have won the centre clearances 14-5 tonight. This is the biggest one coming up.
And they've sent Fisher forward to man up the man Murray spoke about, O'Halpin. Warnock the clean tap, but the Saints win the clearance. Gilbert taking it wide. 2 Blues converge. Dygan heroic in the last quarter. Simpson gains 30 metres or so. Saints have it covered. Dempster, maybe a couple of minutes left. Big aerial ball here. Sam Fisher slamming Sam. Montagna, Saints come again. Who can snare this out of the air? Satanta.
Who else?
But what happens next? What happens next? He plays safe. The two blokes who argued at 3/4 time, Thornton, and he plays safe. And it's Carlton's turn to soak up some time. And Jordan Russell in his 100th.
And Sam Fisher's given into that calf, that cramp in the calf, Tim. He's had to come off. He's been heroic.
They need someone down the line, the Blues.
It's getting harder here for Carlton. Thornton taking no chances. Bombs out to halfback. Warnock in amongst it. Goddard. Del Santo's been magnificent in this last quarter. Oh, Snyder ran around it. Had to go back and try and get it again. Gilbert, desperation everywhere. Montagna into the 50. Milne with a delicate tap. Blues trying to desperately get it to the line. Is there a whistle there? No. It's O'Halpin to come at it again, and he knew where to take it. He's been here long enough to know that. It's over the boundary line again.
This is as tense as it gets. Saints pressing for the winning goal. Jack Stephen buried. Absolutely buried. Oh, here it is. In Jordan Russell's 100th. The Blues win by 3 points.
That is an epic.
scenes down here. That was some sort of a game. At three-quarter time, I was over at their huddle, Jordan Russell, and they knew they had you. They believed they had you. Explain and describe the pressure that your back half was under in that last quarter.
Yeah, it was pretty immense. We obviously knew they were going to come out strong. They've had the best at every start of the year. We knew they were going to come out firing, and they did, and we just had to grind it out, and in the end, we got lucky.
What's the mood like? What's the feeling like when you know that they're coming at you and they've got all the run and they truly believe and you guys have just got to stick fat and hold on like that? What's it like to be out in the middle of all of that?
Yeah, especially when they're coming, kicking a few goals, it's pretty tedious, but we all got really good belief and we know we can come through with the goods.
Mick Dygan's performance was unbelievable. What a difference he's made to this back six or seven.
Yeah, for sure. He's come back and fit in really nicely. Really helps out Jamo, myself and Yaron personally.
Now, you get a break the first 7 weeks. Is it taking its toll on you and taking your toll on the group?
Yeah, I mean, every time you get a bye, it's spot on. We need a rest. I'm wrecked, and I'm glad we got the 4 points.
What a way to celebrate the 100.
Perfect. Couldn't ask for a better way to win it.
Good on you, mate. Well done.
Well, I wonder how they're feeling in that St Kilda camp. They'd have to be proud, but again, the 4 points have eluded them, Malcolm.
Yeah, someone was going to be very happy. I think I mentioned it late in the call, and you just know that the disappointment of that loss to them is going to hurt. Gee, it was an exciting game, though, wasn't it? I mean,
fantastic.
But someone's got to lose, unfortunately.
Back to you, Murray.
Thanks very much, Danny, with Nick Dygan. A year ago, you're playing in front of 500 people, and no one carries on like this in a game of footy. What's it like to be in the middle of something like that?
Mate, sensational. You can really feel something around the club building. I mean, I'm just thrilled to be a part of it, mate. It's awesome.
You look like you're not afraid at the moment.
No, I suppose I was recruited because I took the game on, and if I don't take the game on here, then I probably won't get a game, so I just got to keep doing it what got me here.
Is it hard to trust yourself? I mean, you're playing at the elite level, immense pressure. You're just to back yourself, to have that belief.
I don't know, mate. That's just the way I've played my footy, so maybe just it comes naturally.
What was it like to be in the middle of all of that in the last quarter?
Mate, that was awesome. I'm really starting to get a feeling for the club, and so that one meant a lot. We worked bloody hard for it, and, mate, just wrapped to get away with the win.
It was a great win. Well done.
Yeah, thanks very much.
Back to you, lads.
26-year-old recruit. Three times he marked opposition kicks forward in that last quarter.
No, he was very good.
But St Kilda didn't deserve to lose. They played so defiantly when they really were facing defeat.
11-18, though, to 12-9. I mean, they had their chances in that third quarter and blew it a bit, didn't they? They probably shaded them on the day, shots at goal.
They showed there's still life.
Oh, yeah.
There's still a chance to be there in September.
Maybe. Only maybe.
Some wonderful reactions there. It was always going to be a massive contrast on the sideline with a scoreline like that. The Blues somehow got over the line again. That's three terrific wins where they've been behind late in matches. 11-18, 84 to 12-9, 81. Four goals to Stephen Meal. Garlett, brilliant, particularly in the first half. Kick three. Gibbs and Walker a couple, including that crucial one late for Carlton. They've got home by three there. Happy boys in the room.
Terrific Jordan Russell in game number 100, and the Blues love it. You're about to speak to the coach downstairs, Blight. How do you think Brett Ratner would be feeling?
He'd be relieved, I'll bet. Absolutely.
Let's find out. Andrew Marr is down in the rooms with Matthew Lloyd and the coach.
Yeah, let's ask him. Hello. It's a tough way to make a buck. How does the coach feel 10 minutes after the final siren after a game like that?
Probably relieved, I think, with the amount of shots we had at goal again. And I think every quarter we out, you know, we had more shots than they did, and then maybe to be behind and have to rally. But I think it's character building for us. I think it's showing our mental toughness has improved from last year to this year. And I think the blokes will get a lot of confidence going into the break with that.
Andy asked Jordan Russell about Nick Dygan, and his poise, I thought, was unbelievable in that second half.
Yeah, I think it's been a credit to the recruiters and that to try and get an older bloke in that back half, and the way he's gone about his footy, he's just come in, he's got nothing to lose, 26, and he's just putting it all on the table, and he was fantastic at the end.
They believed they had you three-quarter time. I was over at their huddle, and they felt like they had you on toast. They felt that you were spent, your legs were heavy, and they were going to run over the top of you. Did you sense at three-quarter time that the group was fatiguing?
We thought that we kicked 1-5, I think, in the third quarter, and that probably hurt us a fair bit, I suppose, with doing a lot of hard work. And then towards the end of the quarter, I think they had about 5 or 6 inside 50s to about 1 or 2. So they had about a 5-minute run on towards the end. So I can see where that confidence come from. We thought our last quarters have been fantastic in the season. So we sort of asked the players, you know, where we've been before, what we needed to get the job done. And we got headed and we fought back again.
And Brett, when Jason Graham did kick that last goal, obviously you would have known how much time there was left. Do you send out a message to the players?
Well, we had, I think Chris had gone on a little bit before, and then Simo was about to go back on. So we told Simo there's about 3 minutes or so to go, and we had to try and get another shot and how we could manufacture that. I think it was just a great kick by Robertson to Walker.
The last 2 weeks, though, Halpin's been pretty important. He's always kind of struggled to find a place where he really fits in this footy team. Have you seen something in the last fortnight where this new 21-1 rule might actually be sort of playing into his hands? He might have a more relevant role to play in the new system?
I think the bigger types that are really versatile and can play many spots, I think will be something that teams use as a strength for theirs. And you see Lee Brown do it. He can play fullback. I think he played on Lindsay Thomas in one of the games, and then plays forward and ruck. And I think Satanda has those attributes to go from one end to the other. And he'll be very vital for us as the season goes on.
And Brett, how much did last week take out of Chris Judd? Really thought he struggled with 9 disposals in that first half, but he was enormous after half time with 18 disposals, and really lifted when you need him to.
Yeah, he's. I think he's just. You know, he's just the ultimate professional, and he would have knew that at half time he'd only had one touch in that second quarter, and just led from the front and really responded great.
What did you make of the Jamison Revolt contest? It was one that the boys upstairs were focusing on a lot. It was a fantastic man-on-man duel. How did the coach see it?
I don't think Rue sort of hit the scoreboard, which is fantastic for us. But I thought Jamison probably held the points. But as the third quarter got going, I think Rewald got a few hit-up leads and really started to work his way into the game. And even towards the end there, he threw himself in to take a mark. And I thought it was a great battle. And I'd probably have our bloke just in front.
What about now for the Blues? Do you reassess where you're going this year? Is it now top four, the goal with the position you've got yourself in?
Not really. We don't change. We've had some things at the start of the season that we put in place, and we won't change our goals. We get a break now. The players will have a couple of days off, 2 or 3 days off, but we'll be back in on the weekend and full steam ahead.
Congratulations. It's a fantastic performance.
Yeah, I might need the break, I think.
I think you will. Back to you, Hutto.
Thank you, Murray.
Did he say relieved?
He did say relieved.
That's all right. I just wanted to make sure I heard that. Yeah.
A couple of points to have a look at again here. There was so much going on in this game. It was an absolute beauty. But the free kick not paid to Stephen Milne. We mentioned there was a lot missed, or the umpires decided not to pay. Was that a free kick in your mind, Malcolm?
I've seen worse paid against, certainly over the shoulder,
yeah,
didn't it?
Clipped him under the ear. That was also crucial, but kicking a goal has been this thing that's been talked about a lot. It was a problem for Carlton tonight, but not for Andrew Walker, when it absolutely mattered at the end of the game.
I reckon you might remember this one. You know, there's some kicks over your career you probably remember, and great kick from Robertson, wasn't it? I mean, there wasn't much room anywhere there. Look, St Kilda players back, and just tripped us back nicely and didn't hit the post. It was obviously a goal. We're pretty happy with that.
Yeah, and rightly so. Terrific performance from Andrew Walker. Now, Thursday night's on one. If you haven't checked it out yet, make sure you get your guide to the weekend. A couple of likely-looking bunch there, Blighty.
He's a good-looking fellas there, aren't they?
For the game plan. Mick Malthouse is our special guest panellist, as he regularly is. And, of course, that's on the eve of Geelong and Collingwood. So it'll be fascinating to see what he has to say Thursday night. Now, things are going... Look in the middle of Andrew Marr. There's Carlton are 4 goals up at this stage. He's yawning.
It's a good look, isn't it, that?
Oh, it's disgraceful.
It's just a wonderful thing called TV.
All right.
He must be a breakfast radio host. We'll take a break, and the Blues are happy. Styx Kernaghan making the presentation, of course, to Jordan Russell. Played few better games than he had in his 100th. Been outstanding. We'll take a break. There's more to come from Eddie Hand after this.